or later, but must. The dam will burst and everyone will break out. And we'll stop them. The force. Which force can stop this river of ones who already know their course? The force is a centenarian. And that is far too old. 150 years of brute force. Don't tell me them not cold. Them cold. What do we have here? Black History Month? Reggae Month? I love this month, but I don't worship the idea. Straight up, we'll use the time to clarify the year and strengthen the resolve of the African and all of the freedom lovers. Mabrak, news flash. Babylon plans crash. Thunder interrupt their programs to announce. Black electric storm is here. Straight up, Mondays to Fridays, 9 till midday. Mondays to Fridays, News Talk 93 FM. I'm Robin Bongo Jerry Small. You're old straight up. Yes, another grip. Good morning. Welcome to Straight Up for today. Thursday. No, Wednesday. Thursday is a bit previous. Wednesday the 3rd of January. I'm your host, Jerry Small. We're broadcasting live here from the studio of New Start 93 FM. The metals there singing about prayer being my daily food. And yes, it can be, and yes, it do well. Prayer being a daily food. And then now the Harvey, my name Reverend Harvey, or Dr. Harvey, or Professor Harvey of the Caribbean, Northern Caribbean University, and the PNP. Reverend Harvey of the Northern Caribbean University and the PNP. Is in the center of attention because of some comments he made. Was it after he prayed or was it before he prayed? We have burning spear there. What did he say? And what did he pray? What did he pray? And then what did he say? May we hear from burning spear, please.
Birds that they quietly cease. Foxes in their home. Man at their peaceful rest. He has no way to lie. He pray. Yes, he pray. He pray, yes, he pray. He pray, yes, he pray. Yes, he pray. He pray, yes, he pray. For I and you. You pray, just pray. Yes, pray. Yes.
Yes, and pray, but what did he say? So the pastor, he said that he went overboard. He went overboard the pirate ship. But we'd have to hear what him say and what him prayed. I haven't heard what him say. I mostly hear reported speech. Reported speech, what him say and what him pray. Did he go overboard? Did he not go overboard? Did he clarify that he was not speaking on behalf of his church, the Adventist church or his university? Was he speaking in his context as a citizen, a citizen, which is his right? And even a pastor have a right to choose a political direction and team and policy. But what did he say? Let us hear. We need to hear what him did pray and what him did say. I understand. I get a report here. This is I just get reported speech. In other words, what somebody say. But I have a quotation which is direct speech, not in sound, which is the most reliable one, but in print, coming from where? Which paper is this coming from? Anyway, it is describing Portia Simpson Miller as one who is in touch with God. Harvey said, "Our country and the party need a great leader to lead us through tough times. Someone who is socially aware, one who has a genuine love and can empathize with the people. That's who this country has in the leadership of Comrade Portia Simpson Miller and our lieutenants." So he is validating and endorsing the comradeship and the lieutenantship, even though she said that there's no one there worthy to loose the lace off our foot. Loosing the lace off our foot, you know, is an analogy for someone visiting or someone who has walked hard or has worked hard, and you are encouraging them to take a rest. So you loose the shoes off of their foot, you bring them some water and allow them to wash their feet, and you give them some refreshment. That's the whole analogy about loosing the... And also, if the person is to be baptized or the person is to be treated or to be helped in some way, you loose the shoes off of them foot and give them a rest from the journey. And she said there's no one, in other words, she said there's no one worthy to give her a rest. In other words, to loose the shoes off her foot and tell her, say, all right, take a rest and sit down and put your feet up. So he's endorsing the lieutenantship of the lieutenants while she is not really doing so. And the comradeship and the leadership of her, specifically of her, not just the leaders. As some people sometimes pray for the leaders of Jamaica or the leaders of the United States, the leaders of the country, of the community. He's specifically speaking at a meeting, a rally, to win more power. He's speaking at a rally. He's not praying for the leadership of the country or leadership generally. He's praying for the leadership of the halfway tree, massive, and the People's National Party. This is the first time I've seen him direct words. Some of them, I would like to hear it and assure myself that he's not being misquoted. So now let us hear what did he pray. We haven't heard what he prayed before he said, or did he talk before him pray? Did he talk to the people before him talk to God? Or did him talk to God before him talk to the people? What did he say? What did he pray? Remember, you're from Big Youth. I pray thee.
Why do thee then race and the people imagine of such vain things? Vast kings of the earth that set themselves from the ruling state councils gather. Against the Lord God's a Rastafari and against his anointed saying, now come let us break their bands of sunder and cast away their gods from us. The holy that seateth in his heaven shall laugh. The Lord God to Rastafari shall have them in his region. For then shall he speak unto them in his wrath and beg to them in his soul displeasure. For yet if I set thy kings upon the holy mountains of Zion, I will now declare the creed. The Lord God to Rastafari, I had said unto you, and I, that thou art thy sons this day by begotten thee. Now ask of I, and I shall give thee then for thine inheritance, and the uttermost part of the earth for thy possession. Jah shall break them with a rod of iron. Jah shall dice them in pieces like a pot of vessels, I would say. So be wise, therefore, we kings, be struck to thee, fast judges of the earth. Serve the Lord God to Rastafari with fear, rejoice, with tremble. This I and I, the son, unless he be younger, but perish from his ways, good God. When his rod is kindled but the liquor, yeah. And so blessed be all, blessed be everyone, as I would say. And blessed be all they that put their trust in the true and living God, the Rastafari. Cause this man shall be like the holy mountains of Zion that cannot be removed or abided forever. Cause so the mount is round about Jerusalem. And so the Lord our God, the Rastafari, is round and about his people, as I would say. The light of the wicked shall not rest upon this righteous, unless this individual righteous put forth his hands into iniquity. So do good, O Lord God, to Rastafari, unto them that are good, and unto those that are upright in their heart. Cause such as when I turn into his crooked way, don't say. The Lord God, to Rastafari, shall not turn his back to give the count to the right of his people. And you know, come and be me, see them both, so no color. Don't you do Satan, Satan.
Yes, well, apparently the Northern Caribbean University and the Adventist Church have taken exception to Pastor Harvey or Dr. Harvey or Bishop Harvey. No, Adventist Church no carry Bishop. Them no carry Bishop. Them crush Bishop, you know, them stinking insect there. Not the Reverend Bishop, you know, the stinking insect. Well, look like Kalalu, but if it no smell good. Look edible, but it is not edible. Yeah, the Adventist Church, the Northern Caribbean University, apparently take exception to him, involving the Adventist faith in endorsing a certain political party and a certain political leader and a certain political team while not distancing himself. He have a right to do so, but he has not distanced himself, apparently. I haven't seen all the words, I haven't seen the context, I haven't heard the prayer. I've only heard the part of one sentence that he is supposed to have uttered. The part of one sentence. Dr. Michael Harvey, senior pastor at the Adventist Church at Northern Caribbean University, in his opening prayer, touted Prime Minister Portia Simpson as the right leader for the country. So this report is saying that he did it in the prayer. Is it true that he did it in the prayer, or that after he prayed, he made a talk? Did he tout it in the prayer? Is he telling God as well as man and woman that Portia is the right one? Is he telling life? Is he telling it to life? Is it a report that he said it during the prayer? Is it really true that he said it in the prayer? But the Northern Caribbean University and the Adventist Church taking exception to him, taking that liberty. Well, let us hear now. The Northern Caribbean Church proclaim and know that they are Seventh-day Adventists. Seventh-day. They are Seventh-day Christian. You have different numbers of Christian, you know. You have 144,000. You have Trinity, that's three. And you have Seventh-day. And you have one day. Make way from loving there. Because some people are one day. One day, only on the day, they are Christian. Make way from loving there, please.
No true Christians, just cool. You know in this. This one is about those people who curse the sinners, then turn around and do the things that give true Christians a bad name. Them a one day Christian, them a one day Christian. 6 days a week, they doing all kind of wrong. Sunday dress up in a white. Christian, oh no. holla for the Lord, holla for the Lord, holla for the Lord, and enough of them a fraud. See them a come, the sacred cow, with the attitude holier than thou. They don't mingle with non-Christian folk, they don't wanna be unequally yoked. Them, cause me see that them a gone some way, because them go to church every Sunday while me in a bed, I sleep some more, cause me go a party the night before. Them, cause fornicator, cause the crook, but them a do the same when nobody now look. Them a
one day Christian, them a one day Christian, 6 days a week they doing all kind of wrong. Sunday dress up in a white, Bible in their hand, oh Lord, them a one day Christian.
Hear this, I miss a one Sunday morning bright and early. Let me a watch a service on TV, see the preacher a cry openly. That arose my curiosity, so me watch and me listen carefully, while the tears of the parson flowed freely. Then after a while it occurred to me, the parson really a cry for money. Him not cry for the poor family, who have to go to bed every night early. Not cry for the South African country, where black people trying to be free. Not cry for the youth who suffer daily. Him a cry for money. But all of them go have to cry some more when the key man locked the door.
The key man, key man, key man locked the door. Key man locked the door and gone.
Oh yeah.
Key man, key man, key man locked the door. Key man locked the door and gone.
Follow me now, just controlled by greed and vanity. Them a live high with poor people money. They don't give a damn about the congregation, as long as you throw your collection.
Come in. When my pilot come, I take an aeroplane high. I will be so happy with the father by my side. A house is not a home without the Lord inside. So when my pilot come, I take an aeroplane ride.
I miss a pastor not preach on the pulpit. But when you check it out, I'm a big hypocrite. Sunday night, I'm in a church, I pray. Monday, I'm a lead young woman, I stray.
Monday, Christian, I'm a one day Christian. 6 days a week, you're doing all kind of wrong. Sunday, dress up in a white, Bible in the hand. Oh Lord, I'm a one day Christian.
Follow me now, hear this. Say, are you Christians everywhere? And you may attack, so have no fear. I beg you, don't feel no way. Just hear me when I say.
Yeah, them go party last night. Loving dear, sir. Well, it was actually Sunday night, them go a party. But it look like them stay the party. Them are 7 day party people and 1 day Christian. Some are part day Christian, not even whole day. And nothing wrong with that, as long as you know where them stand. Well, last week, the same report said, last week while at a workers' meeting, the PNP senator, I money Duncan Price, said that Simpson Miller said that our master will touch her today. Simpson Miller say, our master, I don't know if it's who I go touch, get touched, but anyway. Yes, let us hear now from the Mellow Larks. This is from way back, 1960, I believe it was. 60 or 61. Time to pray. When we look at you with that music, we are kick up in it. Nice.
Pray, oh, down to Adam place for in Satan. We gonna pray, we gonna pray, we gonna pray, we gonna pray.
Man, that's Rico Rodriguez. I back them up with that double bass and hand clapping. Pre-ska. Pre-ska. Time to pray. Big, big hits. Religion and faith and music and entertainment and teenage dance part, everything I want. Yeah, man, we love them things from them time. The time the folks, brothers, youth and youth monks, we'll kick up and make them record their music. But, I want to play a piece of music named Passing Through Dallas, Texas. Passing Through Dallas, Texas. Because Dallas, Texas reports some more of the Zik V after the little youth from Jamaica pass through Dallas, Texas and pick up the Zik V according to them, because through them want to shield the garrison that they want to make Portmore into. They want to make Portmore into their garrison. They don't want Portmore to be free. They want to have Portmore locked. And through that now them don't identify where the Zik V rise up in a Jamaica and them say it passing through Dallas, Texas. Let us hear it. Passing through Dallas, Texas. This is not passing through Dallas, Texas. We'll soon find the right passing through Dallas, Texas. But anyway, them claiming that them no want, just like with the just like what them never want to identify. What is what them never want to identify the other day? Never want to identify something or another. Don't want to identify. Don't want us to pinpoint anything. But anyway, I want to correct myself. It was more than 3.5 years, more than 4 years, that there was a one-party parliament in Jamaica between 1983 and 89 February. As a matter of fact, it was 5 years and 3 months, the longest term that any government, any so-called government has served in Jamaica, any so-called elected government has served in Jamaica, 5 years plus the 3 months over Siaga did take to stretch it as long as possible, because him now said the bell toll for him, Him for who the bell toll, but not in a nice way. So it was not 3.5, 4 years that Portia Simpson Miller was out of the parliament by virtue of Michael Manley leading the PNP to stay away from the election of 1983, the so-called election. It was actually 5 years and 3 months. 5 years of 3 months of the longest reigning regime of human trafficking from civil when the Spanish come grab the place by gunpoint to Port Royal, when the English come grab the place by gunpoint and the point of a sword, to Spanish Town, to Halfway Tree, to Morant Bay, and from Morant Bay to Mobie, from Morant Bay 1865 to Mobie 1963. Longest reign of terror, the longest single reign of terror. 5 years and 3 months, the Siaga-led government of 1983 to 1989, February the 9th. Welcome back to Straight Up. Just before I take a phone call, our Yale Tallman, the taxman from Papin to Avery, sometime from 3 Mile to Papin, Tallman, otherwise known as Icon. I look like I come out of him taxi yesterday evening and I pay him, you know. Come out of Tallman taxi yesterday evening, Avery, and it look like I don't pay him. I'm not sure. Because I still see myself with the $200 in my pocket. $100, you know, but $100. I expect to see $100 when I look and say $2. I look like I never pay tall man. Was it so? Tall man, Icon, from 3 miles to Papi in taxi. Our Yale Terry Richards, whose birthday was on the 1st of February. Terry Richards' birthday was on the 1st of February. Went play piece of music with Terry Richards, Lickamore. But Clifford Clark, also the trucker from Mobie. Trucker from Moby, straight up. Appreciate the support, same way as usual. And also, Dundee's, my runner Dundee's, man. Dunno, old time human rights campaign and soldier. Dundee's, running to him yesterday, it was so great to see Dundee's. Still going strong. Can you believe that? This man's so fit and healthy and bright and sharp. 82 years old. Human rights activist from the, before the early 60s when I meet him, 1964. I see him works from 62. On the wall, him right up all over Kingston. But I meet him 1964 when I was 16 years old. Him just come back from trouble. Him frame him for ganja. Dundee's, dunno. And Yale Raymond Plummer also from Red Hills. Red Hills brethren, Raymond Plummer. And we're going to get back to the phone, but I have two more people for Yale. Junior James. Jimmy Wynn. Otherwise known as O. James. O. James. Gladiators. Them singing Hello Carol. Might play a piece of music from O. James, Jimmy Wynn. Gladiators, little more. And also, that is that. Let's get back to the telephone. Good morning. Welcome to Straight Up. Hello.
Yeah, man, it's a smart.
Welcome, sir.
Yeah. You know, I was watching the broadcast on television.
Yeah.
For the announcement of the election.
Yes.
You know, and I noticed some similarities.
Yeah.
Like the Fly the Gate, Letty and the Pirate.
Yeah.
Song.
Similar to what?
You know, to what had taken in the past when another election was going to be announced.
Yeah.
That same song, Fly the Gate, Letty and the Pirate.
Yeah.
The Prime Minister promising that this term is for the people.
Yeah.
You know, things like that.
Yeah.
You know, so I'm only saying that it is some old things. And we can think about the result after.
Yeah.
The Information Minister.
Yeah.
And the government, they pride themselves on being transparent, but yet no information should be given to the public, like where you should go and naming the people in the
where you should go.
I mean
where you should go.
You know, as I said, naming the stations that sell the bad gas.
Yes, exactly.
Where
what
you should go to buy gas and so on.
Exactly what
should go.
Exactly what I was trying to remember a while ago. Don't want to name where this Zikvi has been found to protect themselves so that they can hold Portmore as a garrison. And don't want to name where the bad gas is. Protecting the bad gas sellers, protecting the companies, protecting the friends them, who are giving them money, who are donating money to them.
Most definitely. You know, and these things... You know, I think, and I don't want the JLP take no comfort in a year and me saying anything like me battering the government, you know. But because they are the government of the day, you get me? You know, we have to just say what we notice is happening.
Yeah.
You get me? And Rick Van Winkle, wait too. That is another thing. Because over the years, we have been hearing anything from the administration, you know, with regularity, especially on important national events. And now we hear about the how much was the 3 press conference per week.
Yeah.
You know, and I hope whichever administration form the government after this, them know, say, them forgive it, them forgive a regular update. I don't want them tell about the transparency and them hide things, like we're stupid.
I don't need any update from them. We will find out things for ourselves. I don't need an update from them, but I'm glad if you get update. I'm glad if you get update.
Yeah, because we must hold them responsible, you know. Yeah? Yeah?
Yes.
But anyway, you know, as usual, we listen to your program and we listen to some interesting things coming forth, you know, and even your explanation with those who you can get. Calling them because yeah. Sometimes, you know, as I said, they're addicted to the program.
Yeah.
Because they have to listen.
Yeah.
Must. All right. Go on,
you. Thank you very much. The other thing is, as you say, criticizing the government is not endorsing the GLP, because whichever party is in government anywhere in the world is subject to more scrutiny because they have all of the privilege and they are doing the things. So they must be criticized more. They must be observed more. And if they're doing good, they will be commended more. Now look how sloppy the JLP is. in Northeast St. Elizabeth, where the PNP is in trouble. The GLP had a candidate. Something go wrong with the candidate. Them not communicated people. Them wait until the last moment and then put in Dr. Safia Langmore, who put up a good contest with Hilton in East St. Andrew last time. But she was pregnant. Now she is free from pregnancy. Not free, but she's past pregnancy. And at the last minute, them announce her something like half dead weight. They are incompetent.
Very.
Thank you.
Very.
Thank you very much.
Yeah. All right.
Good morning and welcome to Straight Up. Welcome. Hello. Are you there?
Yes. Over there.
Yes, sir. Welcome.
Welcome. You know some of that.
What go on, sir? Yes, sir.
The person who you just pick up, 782.
Yeah, man.
His name, see in a moment. Murray.
Yeah, man. Don D's.
Don D, man. He means example that I follow. I'm just 3 years before me, but he's a sharp.
Yeah.
And then he's an inspiration to I continue to do what I do.
Boy, I couldn't believe that the man so senior, you.
Eh?
I couldn't believe that you so senior.
You can't kind of comment. Between myself and what I take charge of myself in the natural way.
Yes, sir. Well done.
Yes, mind, body, and spirit.
Exactly.
I know the program is not a complete program, but this is an avenue through which complaint can come through, because it seems that officials and authorities listen to it because it's a biting program. Now,
yes.
For 3 days now, I'm trying to access a bonus $100. I have a car, I can do it $100, but the whole thing aggravates me. My brother sent me a digital top up during the time, 1st and the 7th of February.
Yeah.
We get the bonus and the extra $100.
Yeah.
And some for data. Now, data I don't have, and I'm not worried. But 3 days now, I do everything them tell me.
Yeah.
And the most I can get sometime for the answer. This whatever is temporary and available.
Yeah.
So now, yeah, be dishonest, Jerry. If you decide to give people a bonus, let them get it, no? At one time earlier, you know, you could just get the top up and the bonus.
Automatically.
No, why is this change? No, if them not trusting people, I can understand. But for God's sake, man, 3 days now, you go up on the phone, you get that thing, press this, nothing happened, you read tickle, and you come off and say, this thing is not, it's temporarily unavailable.
Yeah.
I was in Baraka this morning, it's 3 days now, man, try.
Yeah, man.
Just to find out if it's my fault.
Yeah, man, we have a ball out about these things. Several times.
Not only that, when you call 100, and them give them menu, at one time, you could come to a menu that's a technical support,
yeah.
And you press it, and you get a customer service person, a human being to talk to, who can solve a problem. Nowadays, that's not the planet.
No.
You know something, I don't trust government. Whether it's Jamaican, Russian, none of them.
Yeah.
That's the other thing. And now I begin to don't, well, I never did trust, but I do have much faith now in corporate man, especially in these, increasing the welfare now, technology nowadays.
Yes.
It leaves us bewildered and confused. I am not going to be bewildered and I'm not going to be confused.
No.
I can't do without them as much as possible.
Yes, we can.
No. But I mean, there are people, I will be active.
Yeah.
To support people. We'll try to bring them to book. But I'm not going to get myself personal thing, but I just have to say that.
Yeah.
You know, this is a ministry of small things as usual.
Yes,
small
things that make the fun. Yes, a lot of businesses behave just like politicians.
Yes.
And and a lot of times businesses and politicians are in cahoots with one another, like what Malcolm is telling. They're in cahoots. They are in cahoots.
The corporate business, the big one, no control government. Look at it. Because if the corporate business say to government, try to do something, and the government officers do not respond that way, let me draw them funding and them help.
Yeah, man. Thank you very much. Here, sir.
Yes, sir. One love. Rest
yes, sir. Life. Next one. Good morning and welcome to Straight Up. Hello. Next one, please. Morning. Welcome to Straight Up. Hello.
Yes, Jerry.
What one, sir?
You see, when I hear people say them don't trust government, you know, I sympathetic to these people too, you know.
Yeah.
You know, see, if
call about, give me, I get the next call.
Yeah, all right, thank you very much. Next one, please. Another.
Hello.
Good morning, welcome. Straight up, hello.
Hello.
Next one, yes, sir.
Mm-hmm. Do you realize that Pastor was roped in by the Roper?
That what?
Pastor Harvey was roped in by the Roper.
By Pastor Roper?
I didn't say that, Jerry. Pastor Harvey was roped in by the Roper.
Was he busting by the JUTC?
No, this man, don't beat me up, sir. I'm telling you what I'm telling you.
Was he giving enough rope to hang him hot?
Yes. So
he was did he hang him hot where him can't reach it?
Yes, that's what he did.
Well, that's why I don't climb on no arm ladder or no stool and I am.
Once I did some work out by the Coast Guard, you know, the Coast Guard officers, naval officers, do you know that they don't walk on a ladder?
They don't walk on that ladder. Superstition.
Yeah, they don't, and I mean, they rather put up a ladder, they said to me, I rather put up a ladder to go over the next ladder, but they're not going to walk on it.
But it is wisdom, it is wisdom, especially when you are on sea, on board a vessel at sea.
You be
careful about those things, but after a while, it rises to a level of superstition and omen, and being an omen, you know, a foreboding of evil, or sometimes you can have good omen, you know. Well, it can have. Well, omen is a thing imaginary. People can entertain good omen because somewhere entertain them in their mind. Strictly mental. Entertain bad omen, entertain good omen, all kind of entertainment.
Yeah. But you know, what I have to say when I listen to the whole thing is that I don't see how they want to criticize this man now, because didn't we have a pastor that was called the the one was the Anglican pastor there, but the Anglican priest there, man. He was called the Red Priest. You remember him?
You mean Ernley Gordon?
Jerry, why you want to be called
Reverend Ernley Gordon, or is this who you're talking?
No, this was my parishioner, you know.
Parishioner, but that have nothing to do with the shades of red.
I was saying to somebody that the first woman I was in love with, I was a young man, young boy in his 60s, and somebody was staying, a teacher was living at this was a step grandmother's house, and I mean, I was in love with the woman, fat woman.
Yeah.
Yeah, and I know you and the girl thing, I mean, can't get along about that. Right. But I mean, I remember all of that. So it's not strange enough to see the Adventist man coming out.
Yeah.
There's nothing new.
Coming
I
out.
I remember them things. There's nothing new. It's
coming out. All right, well, thank you very much. We have to go for a break, but thank you, sir.
Well, good.
Thank you very much. Welcome. Well, thank you very much for being corrected. Apparently I said it is today is the 3rd of January. Today, of course, is the 3rd of February. Thank you very much, Boya, for correcting me, if it is so. And I believe that I have no reason to disbelieve that I did say the 3rd of January. That's neither here nor there, but it is worthwhile to be corrected, of course. Thank you very much. Good morning and welcome to Straight Up. Hello.
Hi, morning.
Hey, hello, how are you doing?
Morning, Daya.
Yes, ma'am. Are you underwater?
I beg your pardon?
Are you underwater?
What do you mean by that?
Are you a submarine? I thought it was a war boat, but it sounds like you're a submarine.
Watch out. Look here. Let me just start my talk and come on for your program, yeah? Because you look like you look wide this morning.
And it sounds like a surface now.
up
periscope.
Eh?
Up periscope.
Up, all right. We're going to use the word up too. I was at the bus stop yesterday, you see?
Yes, ma'am.
And the ear was huge. In time of 26.
Same as 20.
I talked to a hard man. The man said, a hardcore PMP.
Yeah.
So me hear the youth, like, you know them people there, them hardcore PMP, they like, you can't change them.
Yeah.
Them bent a certain way.
Yeah.
Same as talk to them things, and me hear the youth, I say, I'm 26, and him, man, come see one party around this country.
Yes.
And him say, him not see nothing better. Things in life not better. A high school student, class mother, go good school, you know.
Yeah.
And him say, the only little break him did say, that little 4-year period, then, you know what the break him say? The main thing when me hear him emphasize, fans. The police send it under some control. And the place never dirty the place. They clean up and garbage used to collect and all these things.
Yeah.
And him say, from after that time there to that time there, you know which little periods I'm at, break. Instead the thing just a go up, and then my people not hear nothing. Me hear the guy, I say, him like him numerating in a one area, and him living another parish. And him want vote, and that's all him at him. So when the youth don't talk, me tell you, say, the PMP man, the ardent PMP man, is shaking head and say, true you talk, youth. You get to the man, you know.
Yeah.
And get to them, I was so impressed.
Yeah.
You know them, where them students never come from, the boarding school, don't say, you know them can articulate.
Yeah, right? Yeah.
I saw the youth sound.
Yeah.
And I tell them, I was so impressed. But what is Portia going with? You have a word, you have a phrase where you use all the while. Delusion of grandeur.
Yeah.
You know that Portia is in that.
Yeah, she's here. Yeah.
Like them lie, she lie, them lie.
Oh, hold on. Which lie Portia tell?
No, man, but Portia will say this. And you know Portia not do that. Portia will say, say this and she mean something else. Them just can't come and talk the truth.
No, but if you say somebody lie, you can't just,
Alright, them tell, look here. It is so much light overwhelming that me can't really go pick out. You see, me never really come for come.
No. If you are, stop now. You can't go as far as to say somebody a lie, and at the same time, you can't quite remember what them say. No, if you're going so far as to say somebody lie, you could never have the excuse that you can't remember.
Alright, listen. Never come back with some lie in a lie. Right? Me not because my head don't really depend on that, your mother not treat you good.
Hold on a little. You've been talking for a while, so let's discuss now. Mm. So you're willing to discuss the allegation until you come with an example then?
No, me not going to discuss that.
No, well, I can say that not only Portia, but the whole of them have delusions of grandeur.
That's what I said.
Would you allow me, man? Hold on. Me allow you for about 2 minutes now. Okay, and we are trying to discuss for like 1 minute now.
Yeah.
So I can say, and I know that I have the it has been demonstrated to me that they are deluded with grandeur.
Yes.
And even people on the other side, all of the politicians, yes, the whole political culture in Jamaica is deluded with grandeur.
Yes.
And it can be demonstrated easily. So yes. So it better you withdraw that, and it better withdraw that until you can demonstrate it. It's very.
No. You know some other them type. Let me not have withdraw what the whole Jamaica do. We're not going to draw them, lie.
All right, so you're
going to draw.
All right, so
you just come back it up.
All right, so you're going to draw away for the time being now.
Yeah.
All right, draw away, but you are not strict, eh? When me and you, Mr. Coombs, you know, remember when people used to say, draw away, strict, eh?
Yeah, draw away, man.
Well, you know what strict mean?
Me know.
What?
Let me know,
Jimmy. I'm asking you what strict
mean. I know what it means.
You don't know. Your Coombs don't know.
All right, I don't know. Hold that.
Yeah.
I can't stop from all. Anyway.
Yes, sir.
Just know the book. It's available. Dr. Mansingh read it with you, but he don't make it nice.
Yes.
Along with Dr. Mansingh and his son, along with the guy.
Two of them are Dr. Mansingh.
Yeah. All right, listen now. You want to go for it with me, please?
Go for it.
Yeah, pick it up.
Where?
Where time Baptist, what's that, a Wolf Road.
Whose place?
129 Old Wolf Road.
Whose place?
Dr. Mansingh.
Pick up what? What I must pick up?
The two book.
Listen. You leave them there for me?
No, man, listen to me, no, man.
I say, how I must pick up the book, then? How are we going to get the book?
You never care.
I must pick up the book, then. I must pay for them, or you leave them for me?
Listen to me, let me talk to you, man. You're going to pay for them.
I going to pay for them,
no, man. And bring my one come. And make you up the money when you reach my house. So you want me to send for them. Yes. You still have to come for my yard.
Yes, well, I'd have a $5,000 head.
And a $5,000?
I'm a big head, bud.
Alright. When we pick up my car, we'll come on my yard for it, right?
I must come on your yard for it.
So how you get it?
Alright, when you get it, me come on your yard for it.
Alright. Listen now.
What? Hold on. You say I must pay for it, and when I come, you pay me back the money.
Me give back the 2001 for me and for you.
Alright. That sound like it can't work, but sound like it can't work. So me have to have $4,000.
No, what 1,000 each?
Oh, and the book name what again?
Home away from home.
Yes, man.
155 here in the Indian.
Man, especially the younger man, sing a good guy, you know.
Right. All right, so make a come to a decision. You're going for them?
Yes, but maybe Mountain after election run.
No. Me go to today.
All right, you
call. So call. Hear me now.
Yes, sir.
Mr. Shah.
Yeah.
talking about the more increase minimum wage 100%.
Yeah.
The 12,000.
Yeah.
The more vote him out with that.
Yeah, in a constituency.
Anyway, we don't have to lose.
Yeah.
Now, as what you said a while ago, candidate just gone in yesterday.
Yeah.
The woman, what's his name?
Dr. Safia Langmore.
Yeah, we just once said one of them have ill health or withdrawal.
Yeah.
All them people say, candidate change that field of champion long time.
No. If the candidate have a medical challenge and have to withdraw, there's no prevention.
I agree.
Would you allow me if you agree with you?
Okay, sir.
Yeah, if the candidate get a medical challenge and have to withdraw, that is that. But the next one that coming in after must be introduced and you should have somebody there working behind the scene. I do have no advice to give them, you know. But if they was ready, that's why I can prove that none of them not ready. None of them is ready to help the people of Jamaica regain them place in the sun. And that is why them don't have a good team of people. Shadowing is not a team. Them dealing with personalities, looking for personalities who can impress people, not looking for a team. And it's not ideas leading, it's personalities leading. Them, leading them.
Where you?
I forgot to annex call. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. Good morning and welcome to Straight Up Along. Next one, please. Good morning.
Good morning.
Before I take your call, can you take the other two numbers, please, or the other two people? Because we might not be able to. Yes, sir. Go ahead, please, sir.
Yeah, Jerry. What may I say?
Yes, sir.
People in Shockwave,
no, talk slow and clear. No, talk slow and clear. No, hold on. Talk slow and clear because I have a jumbly word.
No, man, I'm saying, I'm in a shockwave.
Yeah, shockwave.
Yeah, I can't believe that the one GLP leader,
yeah.
I tell them lies. So, I'm going to try spin things.
Yes.
So, I just leave them for them. If you don't call them conscience, I beat them, you know?
Yes. So what about pastor? What about the pastor at the meetings on there?
No, well, listen to the pastor. He's there for his own ledger. He's doing his own thing. You can't recommend him for say, he never said be here for the university.
Yeah, no.
He might talk out for his own.
Yeah. So, yeah, so you was there? Were you there?
Oh, no, I never get forgot it, but I watch it.
You know, Harold Blair did come to GLP and Siaga Rescue in 1980. You know that?
Yeah.
But you know that after that, PNP win him over to Fedem side?
Oh, no, I'm not have them for deal with the peace management thing. You know?
Ombudsman. Really ombudsman.
Partisan things. Still,
ombudsman.
Know?
And them give about $11 million and whole of money and things nice. The collection nice like what?
For all the peace, if the third year right now argument.
Yes, man, you'll get big contract. Look here, anyhow, you'll come over, you'll get enough big contract, man.
No, and money is a contract.
I know you wouldn't.
No, I just not try it.
Yes, we have our next one. Good morning.
Yeah.
Let him go. Here's an error. He's a mighty error. Morning and welcome to Straight Up.
Neil Bongo Jerry.
Wagwan.
Over there.
Yes, sir.
This is true now, what the PMP did use in the 70s, in the early 70s.
The message?
Yeah, what is the name, the message?
Yeah, the message. My father Banya.
My grandmother Banya.
Yeah.
Who did do that tune there?
Martin, Mr. Martin. Forgot him first name.
Martin.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm watching the PMP thing from the night. I see Mama P really stuck in our time warp.
Yes.
When she used the term, no bastard, no day again.
Yeah. Only boss.
That was one of the lines in the tune to also.
Yeah, man. Because really and truly, bastard, somebody born out of wedlock, was stigmatized and still stigmatized, but more so before 1976 and them time there. So credit can be given to that the regime of that time for regularizing certain things.
Mm.
But them never walk upon water, Michael Manley couldn't walk upon water.
Okay.
So you have to get credit where it is. 10 AM headline news.
Look, come on, I tell you what makes you say them now no bastard no day again.
10 AM headline. What, you tell me something new. News. Good morning and welcome back to Straight Up. I have some text messages. We're into the second hour of the program. We have some text messages. We have some guests as usual, especially because this is Black History Month and this is Reggae Month. We will have quite a few guests, sometimes several on each day. Text messages for today. Jerry, every day you live on PNP, what are you? You must dream about them, especially Portia. On what? And masturbate on yourself. Yeah, I tried it, but it is not helping. portion that helping. But other people is more, so you know, other people get more results. Masturbating and portion not really helpful. It's not that I depend on them, but I find that they can't lift me up. Next one, Jerry, I work at a university in the Papine area, and all know me can't get 4% increase on my pay and retro money. I am frustrated and hungry. I need my money. Please ask the finance minister what is going on at the university. The workers are getting the run around like we are fools. You work at a university in the Papine area, you don't specify, well, Papine area. Even though the university has lands bordering on Papine, it sounds more like it's the other university. Next one, Jerry, do you know who is John Paul White? Big buddy in the PNP hierarchy. The person is asking. Then how you know that Peter King and him was big buddies? And Peter King is not in the PNP hierarchy, or is it Peter King's send the text message? Okay, I understand. I say Peter King's afterward. Jerry, do you know who is John Paul White, big buddy in the PNP hierarchy? And then after that, I say Peter King. I don't know if it's Peter King sign it, or I don't know if you're making sign about Peter King. Next one. Jerry, you are so biased. I don't hear your comment on the pastor that pray at the Labour Right Party in Clarendon. You're too biased. You are getting paid Labour Right, Jerry. You must get a beating, you. Now, hear me now. You are so stupid that I don't fret. But if you're even wise, I wouldn't fret for reading the text message. So whether you're stupid or wise, I will read the text message because they are harmless. They are harmless. I never even hear about any pastor. I didn't even hear about any pastor who prayed at any JLP meeting in Clarendon. It's some reason why we are hearing about this one. You text back and tell me what is the reason why we are hearing about this one. I'm not going to call you an idiot because I don't call the shots. Call me back and tell me why we are hearing about this one and not hearing about the other one. Next one. Or text me and tell me. Jerry, a regular man owing millions in back taxes can't do business with the government of Jamaica, and now someone who does is trying to be an MP. Next one, Mr. Small, Mr. Warmington, seat sure. Some of them who are cursed him not going back in that house. Them are got tired to see him face. Michael Peart, the Speaker of the House, has been an MP, people say, since 92. My recollection is from before 92. I heard somebody saying that Dean appeared to the MP from 97. My recollection is that both of them were MPs from 89. Am I wrong or am I right? In a Mr. Coom style. My recollection, not only that both of them was MPs from 89, but both of them were two of the five, they both together, were two of the five MPs who supported Portia Simpson Miller in our bid to succeed Michael Manley. That's my recollection. Michael Peart, Dean Peart, Horace Daly, Buchanan and Hugh Small. That's the five that I remember. Supporting Portia Simpson Miller and PJ Patterson, not the rest of them. Are the rest of the supporters of the MPs. Michael Peart, Dean Peart, Horace Daly, Buchanan and Hugh Small. That's the five that I remember. From 92. From 92. So therefore both of them must have been MPs from 89. Not 92 and 97. And Michael Peart has said now that he is going to be the last Peart in Parliament because he's confident that his son, who I think is 13 years old, will have no interest in getting into the dirty politics of Jamaica. Peart didn't say that, but he's intimating that he's the last Peart going to be in the Parliament after him father lead the way. Very similar name, Michael Peart, like Michael Manley. So it is that Michael Manley's sons and children show no interest in getting into the dirty politics of Jamaica. I was talking to Joseph Manley the other day. He didn't tell me that. He didn't talk about no dirty politics. But him seemed very averse to getting into anything like that. And what is it about the politics of Jamaica? Why so many members of long-standing political families choose to distance themselves now? Next one. God in you this morning, Jerry. Oh, yeah, play gospel. Me play gospel a while, my wife, you know, me play Judy Moore and the whole of them all the while. Sandra give you a proper sort out last night, or you go buy from the lady who says she has sick. The touch fish taught the truth. Oh, this person sending a letter. And I know who the person is, you know. I know the person who is sending them text messages, you know. You are we expose you? You want to expose you? Text back and tell me if you want me to expose you. Next one, Bongo. Most of the PNP workers in Trelawney don't want former labor right JP White, yet he's being forced on us. Why? Several labor rights have been forced on the PNP, and several PNP have been forced out, and several labor rights have been forced out also. It's all kind of thing. It's not them doing it, you know. It's something happening to them. Try to understand that it's not the PNP doing this. The same thing happening to the JLP. It's something happening to both of them. It's a sign of the times. It's a sign of an eruption to come. It is not them doing it. They are only pretending to be in control. Portia is pretending to be cool. The PNP is pretending to be in control. The JLP is pretending to be cool. Is something happening to them? Something happening to them. Next one. People should be living over 100 and more and still going strong, but it's because of sin our days has been shortened. You agree? The human being, flesh is not designed to run forever. Life goes on forever. Flesh is not designed to run forever. Flesh is a temporary assembly. Temporary assembly. So, shorter days or longer days is not the point. Is human being measure time and fret about time, you know? Human being, time is a human concept. And human beings fret their little hour on the stage. Fret about the little time they have on the stage. Fret about the little 3 hours where they have on the radio. Fret about this and fret about that. Fret about gray hair. A man start painting them hair black because them afraid so them hair get white and all them things. Human beings fret about time. Because time is a human concept. And fret about length of days and boast about length of days. It's not the length of days, and it's the quality. Quality. We're not quarreling now, just a talk. And sometimes we talk hard. Let's get back to the phone. Good morning and welcome to Straight Up. Hello.
Yes, Jerry.
Welcome. Yes, mm-hmm. Yes, Mr. Fak.
No, I get a call and I have to take it, you know?
Yes, yes.
Well, I noticed that the conservative forces boasting that less people have been killed since January. Should they be discussing this? Shouldn't they just stay quiet and watch and see what is happening? Because whenever they do this, they just, like, them just 25. Turn on the people and just continue to do more things. Again, we see it every time.
Yeah. Yes, and what is the thing that concerns you the most?
The concern is, like, is that they are stirring up people who do these things to say, well, they have not done enough and they have to step up back the violence.
Who do you think stepping up the violence?
The people that are doing the wrongdoing.
What?
The people that is doing the wrongdoing, the people who is doing the shooting.
No, you're talking like some people plan and step up the violence. That's the way you're talking.
I don't rule out that possibility. I don't rule out that.
I'm asking you who you think is doing this.
I don't really want to pinpoint nobody, you know, Jerry.
Why?
Because,
why?
Know, you can't answer certain things.
No, you don't have to call them name. Tell me the kind of group. Tell me the kind of group. Describe it.
Well, for instance, we know the scamming, most of it can be caught by scamming because of different reasons. You know, see, we have so much people losing family because they are involved in the scamming.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And the last thing now, Jerry.
Yeah.
They used to use 12 people for jurors. Not that I'm a fan of jurors, you know, because I've seen in court where they give away a lot of cases. Instead of looking through the case, they use their emotion. So I'm not really a fan of them. But right now, I want these people going to get justice because instead of using 12, they are using only 7. Do you see anything wrong with that? Do you believe the people that is before the court will get a good trial?
It is possible to get good results with various numbers of jurors if the case is conducted right, if the judge acting right, and if the legal defense is on their toes. It is possible, and it's also possible to get corrupt judgment with 12 jurors and judge playing a part also.
In that case, you answer the question, so I'll call again then.
All right, thank you very much, yes, sir. Yeah. Next one, please. Good morning. Welcome to Straight Up. Next one, please. Good morning. Welcome to Straight Up. Hello? Other one. Good morning.
Hello, good morning.
Welcome.
Jerry, may I have 3 points to point out here? You know, we live in this country, you know, and I'm mostly con man living in this country, you know, because I listened to a person yesterday evening at this program and tell you that the amount of money that's spent in the 80s, and we don't get value for cash.
Yesterday evening on this program?
Yeah.
This program don't come on in the evening.
Yeah, no, and the other host this program in the afternoon.
This program is not hosted by any other host, and this program don't come up in the afternoon.
All right. No, that's your program, other program. But on your station, on this station here. Okay. You know, when I look at Jamaica, it's outdated in the aspect of life, such as, you know, to buy downtown. Near more the 14th parish, it need the cleansing, and it have done because when you look everything did all dated, and it take cash to care. And when you then guy contact about boy, and it mean know if you had the amount of money that spent in the 80s to clean up Jamaica and put Jamaica in the beautiful Caribbean country. And when you check it out now, they are telling us that your boy minutes is not done of germs are flocking at the country right now, road not clean. Hear me, you can't call them for everything. And these guys are come talk to them, boy, everything, roadie. When we look for in a hospital, when we look for in the water drain, when we look for people cannot get medication to certain type of sickness. And these people are come talk like to boy, people are unnatural. When you look at dollar at the value.
All right.
People like God, poorer, people are getting poorer.
All right, hold on a minute.
And then come, but you see what you read about slavery?
Hello.
Two guys are carrying those strength right now.
All right, hold on a minute.
Yes, sir.
No, so why come to complain about what people say on other programs? We don't want to discuss what people say on other...
No, but you see, I have to make my audience here because some of them did this new program last night and we believe it.
Tell me something. Hold on a minute. I allow you to talk for 2 minutes straight. And as I start to discuss something with you, you're... No, I don't think we're going
to...
All right, hear this now. I already said and clarified yesterday again that whoever is coming defending a political party and don't want to discuss anything, we will allow them to talk for 2 minutes straight and then finish with it. If you want to discuss things, we will discuss it and use up the 3 minutes or 4 minutes. But if you just want to talk your talk alone, you don't want to discuss nothing, you just get 2 minutes. So you get your 2 minutes.
Next one, please.
All right. No other thing. Because you don't really want to discuss nothing. Let's run the numbers and we have a guest. Please call the guest, please. Thank you very much. Now, this month is not only Black History Month around the world. It's Reggae Month in Jamaica and possibly around the world. Now, we have several guests here. Musically connected. Who is Stuart Wilson?
Well, Stuart Wilson is somebody who is... taking music as something that can heal the world, something that can heal people, heal hearts and minds of broken hearts all around the world. And Stuart Wilson is somebody who God is using to make music that can play a role in that healing.
So are you based in Jamaica?
I am indeed. My father is a Jamaican. I've lived back and forth. I was born in the Cayman Islands. My mother is a Caymanian. But I've lived back and forth all my life. All my uncles still live here in Jamaica, all my cousins. I live in Kingston, here in Crossroads. So, this is home, you know?
Yeah, so you grew up where?
I grew up back and forth,
Yeah.
Between here and Jamaica. And the Cayman Islands.
Yeah.
Yes.
So, what instrument do you play?
I play the guitar, but primarily I'm a singer, and I use the guitar really as my tool to write as well as to perform. I was trained in guitar from a very young age. I think that we're all kind of born quietly knowing who we are.
Yeah.
And from a very young age, I knew that guitar and had resonated with me.
So you spend most of your time here, Cayman area.
In Jamaica.
Yeah.
Or if I'm touring, I just got off a tour from Thailand where we did 72 shows in Thailand.
Who is you and Wells?
Me and my band.
Oh, what's the name of the band?
The name of my band personally is, it's my band, I call it Love Culture.
Okay. Yeah. When next you going to perform in Jamaica?
I'm not sure. Right now we're doing a promotional campaign. I'm off to the Cayman Islands on the 20th for a performance there.
Yeah.
And then I'm back on the 28th here. And then I'll be probably taking some bookings in mid-March. But we want to focus on really promoting this single at the moment.
Yeah. All right. So, is Miss Chevans, did tell about this program? You know Miss Chevans?
Yes, indeed. And large up Miss Chevans as well, man. And yeah. And I want to big up my publicist, Zaza, as well.
Yeah.
And yeah, we're working with Clive Hunt at the moment. And I've done, this song that we're promoting at the moment is my fourth song I've done.
Yeah, what, tell me about the song.
Well, it's a song about love, you know. It's a song about, you know, the world is busy, everything is happening around us, but we're still in love, and you know, despite all of the busyness of the world.
So where do you record it?
Recorded it here in Jamaica, man.
Yeah.
At Jimmy Cliff's house studio.
I think I just asked, but I don't remember what you said. When next you going to perform in Jamaica?
No, we'll be taking bookings in March, man.
Okay, March. Yes. All right, we're going to play the piece of music.
Enough respect.
Yes.
The name of the track is called Feel For You.
What number?
And it was executive produced by myself, co-produced by Mr. Clive Hunt, you know.
All right.
Dean Frazier on the sax.
Yes, yes.
A new generation, new sensation, and everybody's trotting on their own vibration, own inclination. I feel for you, my love. 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 Everybody's spending all their whole lives wasting, hearts are breaking. Everybody's looking for that special someone, that special someone's looking for you to be.
I feel for you, my love. I feel for you, my love.
I feel for you, my love. I feel for you, my love. Sudden there was love everywhere. We never seen it coming, but we know that it's there for me and you and me.
Yeah, that is the sound of Mr. Stuart Wilson. How long have you been recording?
Well, probably about, I would say now, maybe about 8 years, you know. But it took me a while to find the sound, you know, that I really wanted to find, you know. And it took me a while to develop that sound.
Yeah. So, Reggae Month, so you won't be performing in Reggae Month then?
No, I'll be promoting throughout Reggae Month.
Promoting.
And using that opportunity to bolster my brand.
Mm.
And then we'll be looking at taking bookings again in mid-March.
Yes, yes.
Yes.
And what will you say is a backing musician? I mean, eh?
Well, it's my band. It's my personal band, you know. Youths that I bring from country, I mean, some of them work in the hotels in on the North Coast and stuff like that, and
yeah
man, and we just make it work. Some of them were actually living with me in the Cayman Islands at one point. We we were working over there for like a season, you know.
Mm.
And well, not very long, maybe about 6 months, and then we came back.
By the way, you have some family in the Cayman. You still have Kirk Connell in the Cayman?
Yeah, they're still there, you know.
Them still have boat, or them not in a boat business?
You know, I don't really keep up with them.
Oh.
Because if it's not musical, I tend to just, you know?
and all the rum cake, right? Tortuga,
yeah, man. You know, that is a Jamaican family, you know.
Yeah, what them name?
Hamity.
Yeah, man. Me and them go to school.
Yeah, man.
Come from Westmoreland.
Yeah, man. Good people, man.
I was a pilot. You're a Jamaica pilot.
Indeed. In fact, they're offering my some of my music in their stores at the moment.
Oh, yeah.
You can buy it in all Tortuga rum stores in Cayman and
so them have stores,
at the airport. So. And, yeah, man. They're very well... sort of, yeah, man, good, great company. Everybody knows them.
Thank you very much, and keep in touch with us, Mr. Stuart Wilson.
A pleasure to be here, Mr. Smalls. Enough respect, man.
When you leave, don't leave now. We're going to go for a break. Straight. Welcome back to Straight Up. I'm your host, Jerry Small. And we have now coming into the studio, Mr. Dennis, Dr. Dennis Howard. And we just done finished play Hello Carol by O. James, by the Gladiators. I just woke up on O. James this morning, Jimmy Wynn, one of the Gladiators who sang Hello Carol. Big, big hitter, one of the early reggae music that defined. That don't sound like the original though. But we now have Dr. Dennis Howard. He's putting on a series this month. And I was going to tell you, there's a series of events I'm going to recommend on Jimmy Solo Saturday evenings in Charles Street Hall. It is one of the great events that is ongoing that we recommend people for go. Very wholesome, safe surroundings, everything. Big youth in the year and their man. But this is his son now, Dr. Dennis Howard. Prominent in the music industry, in the academics of music and business of music. And one of the people who helped to shape RFM, the most successful radio venture in Jamaica history. Oh, I'm Dennis.
How are you doing, man? Great to be here.
Yes, sir. What do you have planned? Saturdays now?
Well, in honor of Reggae Month,
yeah.
From last year, this is the second staging. We have set up my company, the Institute of Cultural Policy and Innovation,
yeah.
In association with the Scotiabank Chair in Entrepreneurship and Development at the University of Technology. We started a series called the Reggae Biz Workshop Series. And this is a series of free workshops that we do every Saturday in the month of February. And we look more on the business side of the music industry.
Yeah.
And so we have topics like, for the first one, we're looking at artist management, getting it right.
Mm-hmm.
Then next week, we'll have... copyright, understanding copyright, and for creative enterprises, because it's not just the music industry,
yeah.
You have the fashion industry. There's this issue with people using dance moves that came up recently with the webname Justin Bieber video.
Yeah, yeah.
So people need to understand what it means to you know, negotiate the issue of copyright, because it's a legal issue.
Yeah.
And copyright is one of the ways you earn money from anything creative.
That you created. Ongoing, going on and on.
Absolutely.
Instead of other people just make money off of your thing.
Yeah. And a lot of people really don't understand it. So we want to give them a good foundation in terms of copyright, so that when you go talk to your lawyer, you understand what you're talking about. And then you know your rights before.
Yeah.
You know, so the next one will be Let me look at
these
it
are
now.
Saturdays, right?
Yes, Saturdays. Saturday.
Where is the venue?
It's at the Technology Innovation Center at the University of Technology.
Oh, UTEC.
Yeah, yes, so yes. February 20, it's social media marketing for creative enterprises.
What time of morning is that the morning?
Not morning. We'll do it 1 p.m. to 5 p.m.
Afternoon, good.
Afternoon, good, you know, because you know it's Saturday. Morning, not too
convenient.
Convenient,
morning,
yeah. So afternoon. Yeah. So it's about just a 4-hour kind of
so
seminar.
The first one is what?
About artist management, getting it right. Then the final one, which is February 27,
the first one is this Saturday.
Yeah, yeah.
And that is what? Getting it right?
Yeah, no, man. Artist management, getting it right.
Okay. And the second one next week...
February 13?
Next week, 13, yes.
Understanding copyright for creative enterprises.
Good, good.
The third one, social media marketing for creative enterprises.
All right.
A lot of people know that they can use
social media.
And so, yes, they set up the Facebook, they set up the Instagram, but using it effectively is another matter.
Yeah.
And so we'll bring in some experts who can tell you how to really maximize and optimize the use of social media to promote yourself.
And the fourth one is?
And the fourth one is interrogating hate conflict lyrics towards tolerance and understanding.
Mm.
Now, why I did this one is because I went to Sting on last year, and a lot of the older artists were still on this homophobic lyrics and also dissing each other.
Yeah.
And
cussing.
Cussing each other and man a idiot and all kind of stupidness that don't make any sense right now within the overall context of what is happening in the music globally. And so you can't be parochial and be successful and make money.
Internationally.
You have to be international and there are certain things that you don't touch again. Where if you're going to travel
leave that alone.
And expose, so leave it alone. So we really want to talk about that, the economic impact of continuing to do it, but also the social impact of continuing these lyrics within the Jamaican space. Mm. So we really want to you know move towards
a
behavioral train.
Continuing this kind of thing will dwarf down the thing, make it down grow.
And then you blame the law enforcement and government for the crime,
or you blame them
and the murders.
Fight against the youth.
Absolutely, but
you are good boy and for free the youth.
But the music sometimes perpetuate this conflict and this clashing. Remember the Gaza Gully clash.
Yeah,
it had violent effects on the society.
Murderous.
In the schools and all kind of things.
Yeah.
Some of the presenters for the series, myself, Carlette DeLeon, Jerome Hamilton, Ewan Simpson, Chantel Hill, Dr. Stanley Nyer, Clyde McKenzie, Winford Williams.
Yeah.
And listen, it's free. All you got to do is to register.
We will, if you don't hear me 2 days, you call me, remember. We will be constantly reminding people of the available. And in the last 5 minutes, what I want to do. There's one thing more you want.
Yeah, man. Right. The phone number to register, 906-4515.
I want to leave some flyer or something with those things that we can repeat them.
Yeah, man, definitely. And the next number is 466-6933.
Yeah, great.
All right.
Now, in the last 5 minutes, what I want, for people to understand what is available to them, what you're making available to them, mm-hmm. I want to tell them some of the kind of work we do from 25 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
The setting up and the shaping of IRFM.
Yes.
You are one of the key people who helped to get the character.
Mm-hmm.
Tell them a little about that. I will interject from time to time.
All right. Well, RFM started broadcasting in 1990. I was introduced to the station while I was at JBC Radio. And myself, Clyde McKenzie, Bob Clark, Lloyd Stanbury, and Carl Young were the founding fathers of the concept.
Yes.
So in the early days, I was the programs manager. Clyde was the general manager, Bob Clark became the marketing manager, and of course, Carl Young, the owner and chairman, and the vice chairman was Lloyd Stanbury.
So you say 1990 now?
Yeah.
You already have your experience with JB?
10 years.
10 years?
Yeah.
10 years on top of 25 years?
No, man. 10 years on at JBC at the time.
And then now 25 years with IRE, 26 years with IRE. Not with IRE, but I mean guiding IRE.
No, man. Not so much years, man. I'm not. I. You know the amazing thing.
I know you wasn't there the whole time. Yeah. But 25 plus 10 is 35. You don't have no business.
Yeah, man. That's how long I've been in the business.
That time you're the third farmer, KC.
Yeah. Yeah.
That kind of jacking me to thing.
Yeah. I was very early, young. Yeah. I started
if you have a father like Jimmy Solo, you get a jump start.
Absolutely. So it was one of the most exciting things I've done so far.
Name out the principals when you begin. Carl Young, well.
Carl Young, Lloyd Stanbury, yeah. Clyde McKenzie,
Lloyd
Bob
Stanbury,
Clark.
Lawyer, yeah. Foremost copyright and music
yeah,
lawyer.
And music business lawyer.
Yeah.
And then Clyde McKenzie, another veteran of radio, because he was at Radio Northeast and worked for JBC, which was the community station.
Yeah, yeah.
Bob Clark, a man in the music industry.
Yeah.
And they came up with the idea to start the station, and they went to Carl Young, got the license, and the rest is history.
Yeah.
So we benefited from the fact that a couple of the other radio stations had started, and we saw some of the mistakes. So what we did, we'll give you an example. We didn't even launch the station in any big hype promotion or what have you, because we never wanted to have any problems when we came on here. So we just almost surreptitiously started
low
to broadcast. Yeah. And then
I make the grapevine run.
And then we after everything, we iron out the kinks and stuff, we then started.
That sounds like it well coached.
Yeah, man. And we decided to go 24-hour reggae because we saw it as needed at the time. You know, and the format, initially it was going to be almost like the format of RGR and a JBC at the time, and then we changed that and said, listen, let's focus on the music, not too much talk, don't focus on the too much personality and all of that, and then to play a variety of reggae music that was never played on radio in Jamaica.
I understand that in 30 days,
yeah,
the biggest listenership.
I'm not so sure if it was 30 days, but it was around. It was wildfire. Pretty remarkable.
24-hour listenership.
Yeah, man.
Reminiscent of Red Diffusion.
Yeah.
And people just keep it as a background music in them bar, them shop, them plaza, everything.
Pretty remarkable. And the great thing about it is that it started at the greatest quality. The broadcast quality
was of the highest standard.
You know, and so people were hearing reggae music in a different way for the first time.
Let me say something in the minute that is left. Two things.
Yeah.
Another thing our RFM captured the market. Indigenous advertisement.
Yeah.
Advertisement in patois.
Advertisement absolutely.
Specializing in humor.
Yeah.
Humor. Local language, local events, and then eventually now you're letting some talk that was mostly what? The needs of the people, Afrocentric.
Yeah.
Afrocentric, become the center of Afrocentric discovery.
Yes.
Not exclusively.
With Andrea Williams.
Not exclusively and not anti any race.
Yes.
Andrea Williams, Muta Baruka, all of them.
Yeah. Definitely. And those were all intentional things. We sat down and we worked on the format and decided that is the way we would go. Basically, I don't think the format changed in any significant way in the last 25 years.
If it don't broke.
Don't touch it.
No.
You know, and so I was really honored to be a part of that experience, and, you know, it was a great period.
Yeah.
I'll never forget it. Some great experience while I was there. Had the privilege of breaking a lot of artists.
Yeah.
Tony Rebel, Cutty Ranks, you name
and
them.
1989.
Garnet Silk.
I remember 1989. I carried Tony Rebel, Garnet Silk, and them there. I think it's the first time I ever go to embassy. That time I run taxi.
Yeah.
Me carry them go there. And me carry them three times for the day. Me bought them up, and every time. So run go down at a penthouse. Run go back up at embassy.
Yeah.
Just that time Tony Rebel. A slim little youth, you know.
Yeah, man, I remember it was this.
So now, if the people them get this from you in 15 minutes here and straight up, that is just to demonstrate what they can be getting in these four Saturdays. What do you call the series?
Reggae Biz Workshop Series.
All right, keep in touch and give me something hard copy where I can read back and remind people about.
Definitely. Thank you, man.
And Jimmy Sola, I recommend him, man. Saturday evening, while it's there, safe in a Charles Street.
And I will play vinyl.
Vinyl,
and
you have guest selectors.
Yes, definitely.
And I invite you for pass drop at Wilby's Lounge up at Reddit Road, right side of Price Mart. Wicked and well, it's all, you know.
Oh, yeah, man. Yeah, I know, right over the plaza.
It's a Sunday night, so.
Yeah, man. Yeah.
You do have to divide the time. Saturday, go to Jimmy Solo.
And Sunday.
Saturday nights after you go to Dennis Howard, you go to Jimmy Solo. And then Sunday, you can go up at Wilby's Lounge.
Oh, man.
But thank you very much. It's a taste of things to come.
Respect, Bongo.
Thank you very much. Out of the Reggae Studies Unit and the Caribbean Institute of Caribbean Studies and all kind of different things. Out of them family. Dr. Dennis Howard, straight. All right, how are you doing, my lady?
Yes, Bongo Jerry. Greetings.
Fine, thank you. Introduce yourself and introduce the brethren for me now.
All right, this is Tough Like Iron representing, and I'm here with the Gideon straight out of the Jehovah Evil family.
Blessed, respect.
Yeah, so where are they? Where next, brethren?
he's at the yard, he had a couple of engagements that him couldn't really move, you know?
Yeah.
Recording and mixing and stuff.
Yeah, man. What is his professional name?
Well, his professional name is Sila.
Yeah. A tough icon and Sila.
And the Gideon.
No, and the Gideon. So oh. My twin is Sila.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, so he couldn't make it.
And tough like iron.
I'm tough
she's
like iron.
She's tough.
Yes, yes. And Sila and?
The Gideon.
The Gideon. All right. Yes, well, a Joe son, let me know.
Joe. My Joe brother then.
Yeah.
Oh, you're... Yeah,
man, big say, Joe, man.
Yeah. Say, man, talk about Big Joe. Yeah, yeah. Think of
the
Little
Joe.
Joe.
Big Joe, you know, Coco Maca, big up.
Little Joe step. Yeah. One of your brother's step, right?
Yes, yes.
What's his name?
Little Joe.
Yes, man, him step. Now, Patsy Ricketts is a mother.
Yes, uncle.
Yeah, man, a beautiful dancer.
Yeah, man.
She's somewhat reminiscent of Patsy Ricketts, although she's taller.
Yes.
I love Auntie Patsy. Auntie Patsy, bless up yourself. You know we love you.
I remember the first time I recorded on a stage in 1996 in a ward theater. A set of drummers that come from Ghana.
Yes.
And you're up on the show. You remember them?
Yes, I remember them.
Yes, I. So now, what you have going on? What's coming up?
A whole heap of stuff now. As you can see, we're introducing Tough Like Iron to the world now to the Jack Over Evil Camp.
Iron?
She's like going with a lot of things and bag of things she has going on, you know, making a lot of moves and things. And we have a lot of other projects that in store, but differently from what's in store, we have the album we dropped last year, which is Forever Judah, which was, you know, a dedicated to like Joe, you know, it was dedicated to him.
Yeah.
Also feature his last single, Belly of the Beast, you know?
Yeah.
And things, so, a couple of things, you know, a couple of artists.
So me see you have your cameraman here.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Bless up Soul Indie.
My name?
Soul Indie. We say the Japarazzi.
Yeah.
Yes, and we know we have...
Japarazzi, not paparazzi. I book up Tough Like and all the while out the road. Always making some connection.
That's true. A long time if we come check your door.
Yeah, yes, ma'am.
All right, we're glad to be here. And we're gearing up for Little Joe Memorial Concert this Sunday.
7th.
Yeah. Where?
February 7th at 10:30 First Avenue Vineyard Town.
That's about the time I hear him did step?
Yes, every year the 7th.
Yeah.
Yeah, so.
Vineyard at the yard?
Yes.
Okay, nice. What that road name again?
First Avenue.
First Avenue, yeah. So you're going to have live music or tracks or what?
Both.
Yes, yes.
We have a lot of artists who always come through and represent, everybody love Joe.
Yeah.
And they come and, you know, share our vibes with us, and we are presenting our team, the Jehovah Evil family, with the live band. So some people come with tracks, some people come with acoustic set. Yeah. It's really...
A mixture, yeah.
Yes, I remember when you bring up a whole for you too, you and your mother and your family bring up a lot of other youths that is not natural born in a family, but
yeah, true.
Even Chronics, what Chronics is the name of them start?
Chronics was Little Chronicle.
Yeah.
We never really knew him per se back then when he had that name, you know. But when he came amongst us, he was already Chronics, you know.
Yeah. So now the show will start what time?
We're starting at 8 p.m. You know.
8 p.m. Yeah.
And so everyone try to come out early. It is a Sunday night, so we're trying to do it a bit earlier than usual.
Yeah.
But we're starting at 8, so everyone come through.
Yeah.
They already know the place.
Yeah, what is the, after that, what else you have organized after Sunday coming? What else you have organized?
Well, we also have Dub School, which is every Friday.
Yeah.
God send Dub School every single Friday.
Every Friday.
At 10:30 First Avenue, Vinatown. So yeah. And it's a really nice vibe. As we
what
say,
what time of day?
That would start generally from like 9 o'clock. Mm-hmm. You see the place start getting bubbled in the street, right? 2-3 o'clock.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah, man. Supernova organized that. So Supernova, bless up yourself, you know?
There's quite a bit of, a lot of people don't know that the young people, the young people in Jamaica, the young people in the reggae music industry going on with quite a bit of things. There's a circuit of activity.
Well, the dub school vibe is really a different kind of settings where young artists can come through, you can pass through, we don't have to know you, we don't have to hear your music beforehand, and it's as long as you come and you're ready to represent, and we are playing enough rhythms.
Yeah.
And so it's an opportunity for the young artists to come and showcase themselves and get a following, where some of the sessions you're not getting no chance to get on the microphone.
True.
If you're not a well-known, well-established artist, nobody really wants to hear you. So this is a place where people who are working on their craft can come and showcase their talents every Friday at Jehovah Evil
Dub School. Training ground.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's why we call it school, because yeah, it's really class. We're in class.
You born and grew up Jamaica?
No.
Where?
New York.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
You have Jamaican roots?
No.
Africa.
My father is from Trinidad.
Oh yeah? Nice, mm-hmm. Nice. African roots.
Yeah.
And your mother from where?
My mother's from New York as
yeah,
well.
Yeah. African American?
No, my mother is actually white.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
Well, you know that I saw the world go.
Yeah, man.
Yeah, man. And Bob Marley was a said kind of product, you know, the fusion of cultures.
Is that thing, you know what I mean?
Best of many world. Obama, same thing. So how and when you got attracted to the music?
Yeah, no, I was born attracted to it. The first memories that I have is Bob Marley listening to Stir It Up and them thing there. And I've just always had this connection with Jamaica. I don't really, you know exactly how it start, but as a youth, I was always like, yes, I'll go into Jamaica as a little child, you know? And I came out here first when I was 8 years old, had a big impact on
me. Who brought you?
One of my mother's friends. My mother has lots of friends, so there are lots of Rasta friends and
yeah, well, can't trust
people from the islands and yeah, a sister of hers who actually teach yoga.
In those times, 90 and times before and coming up, lots of Jamaicans complaining, said too much soca play Jamaica, too much this and too much that and carnival and all kind of thing. When me pass through Trinidad, I play reggae me here, I play
yes,
on the radio.
It's true.
You know understand?
Well,
and some people not Trinidad are complaining, but most people are them well comfortable with it, especially the vehicle, the man who drive vehicle.
Yeah.
Bus and taxi and all thing. So the same thing where we are fret about
over there.
Our music
here.
And Viet.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, a lot of reggae music. Well, a lot of dance hall. A lot of dance hall plays in Trinidad.
Yeah. But like, me claim Calypso and all of them too.
Yeah, man.
Yeah.
A Caribbean unity and African unity, and you know what I mean? We yeah. just represent for the whole link.
Yeah. Even when it comes to the nationalism, Stokely Carmichael and all the man, mm-hmm. man come from Trinidad, Marcus Garvey come from Jamaica, them travel all about and them stir up America. And you know?
Yeah.
Malcolm X father come from Grenada, our mother. One of them come from Grenada.
True.
And so it is.
Well, it's a vibration.
Great. It's great. When I ever travel in other Cincinnati together?
No, not as yet.
Yeah.
But them thing they're coming in the future.
Yeah,
you know?
Great. And Sister Patrice is still a nurture there, yeah, the
man.
Family.
Yeah,
she's
man.
Still doing she's the dance as
yeah.
well.
Yeah. Queen Bee, you know? Yeah. Mama P, for real. Yeah, man. Still up and active, very much.
Have a lovely picture, you know?
Yeah.
Would I love to see it, yeah.
I think I printed it on canvas too.
Yeah, nice.
Yeah, man.
Other than that, I also have a new video coming out on Friday for my song Orange Peel.
Oh, yeah.
And we just...
Oh, we should play two pieces of music. Where are we going to play?
Sure.
Why?
You have anything by yourself?
Yeah.
And something by him too?
You bring nothing with you?
Nothing. All right, which one of them you want to play?
You can play Orange Peel, as a matter of fact. That should be number 3, I think. No, number 4.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So we just did an event on Saturday called Steamer Style.
Yeah.
And it was really nice. We had lots of steam chalice fashion show.
Where? At home?
At my brethren's yard.
Where is that?
It was by Mullines Road.
Yeah, not China.
Kevin
yard.
Campbell.
Oh, not China yard. Oh.
No. Near China. Near
Holy China. Holy nice venue all about the place. Up in us, Jacksil all about. Holy pa things are going. Number what?
Number 4. And this is the video that's premiering on Friday. So everybody just stay tuned. Look out for it.
Thank you very much.
Good ganja and orange peel. Good ganja and orange peel. I was walking down the road one afternoon. I'm just chilling, me and my crew. Babylon said, hey, where you are due? 10 weeks if we are passed from two. I've got the chalice and coconut shell. I've got the cutting loaded up well with good ganja and orange peel. And they want to know what's the deal. A good ganja and orange peel. And they want to know.
Yeah, that's enough farm for that's enough.
Give them a sample,
yes,
you know?
A nice sample.
Mm-hmm.
when I go out to a Wiki Waki, I'm going to go around to Chelsea Avenue with the young people, them organizers. I forgot what they call it. Some lovely
yeah, I can't remember the name.
Yes, man, it's lovely.
True.
All wiki waki, what a lovely background and scene, man.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
True, the beach and everything.
Yeah, man, I tell
the deck and thing, man, so them.
And you to name Tafari, Leesla Unlimited sound and all them kind of thing. Was nice to see what I do here.
Yes, sir.
Anytime you need, excuse me, anything that I can do for you. In any upcoming event or anything.
For sure.
Yeah, man,
sure.
Welcome that, you know.
Yeah, man, give many thanks. Man.
Yes, and yell Joe for me.
Yes, man.
Definitely.
My next brother.
I owe him a call too, and I call him.
Yes, yes, and yell your mother for me, please.
Yes, I will, uncle.
Maximum respect. You did grow up in a Maypen too, or just town?
I spent time there.
Yeah, man.
But mainly town.
Yeah, man. Sometimes I want to buck Joe.
Yeah.
And sometimes when I don't smoke again, but sometimes I want a good. With me tour off of the road and go find him in my pen.
I always have it.
And if you don't mind shop, you spend some hours there.
Yeah, right? Yeah, you will. Once you book it.
Thank you very much. Tough like I am.
Yes, Bongo Jerry. Give thanks.
All right, here, sir.
Yes, uncle, man.
We have some calls there and we have some text messages to carry to catch up. But quickly, we have Windy in the studio. Apparently, Windy has secured his bank book, his bank account. Windy, what going? You have a bank book?
Yes, sir.
What going? When you get it?
Just not too long, so don't NC Bank.
Yes, NCB, that's great.
Yes.
That is great. And so in the bank account, you know, NCB, halfway three, and him account number now. We're going to get out of a different time. Him have him account number in case you want to lodge something for him. I don't know many people going to want to lodge something for him. But the other day, did you get something?
Yes, sir.
Did you get something the other day from one of the listeners?
Yes, sir.
What you got?
$10,000.
$10,000.
Yes.
That is how appreciative some of the young people, little children we used to take care of are. Yes, that now become grown and successful people. One of them sent $10,000 to start. And many others indicate, including the security guard on the campus, I said, they have no windy. But they appreciate what they hear so much that the next paycheck him get him going and bring something, no matter how small it is. So it's a joint account. Is that a joint account?
Yes, a joint account.
Who is the person in the account today?
A teacher from Russo Primary School.
Yeah.
That I work with nearly over about 2 years now.
Yeah.
She's a wonderful person. Yeah. Mrs. Robinson.
Yeah. So somebody told you to make it a joint account?
Yes, yes.
Yeah, who?
Because, no, to know her from baby days coming up.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, she's a person that I can trust.
Yes, man, that's great.
So she helping me out.
So who told you to make it a joint account?
Well, I asked her, you know, if it would be wise if she could help me, and then she said yes.
Yes. So, you hope it on the... But it's today date on it?
Yes.
It's not yesterday?
No.
Since morning, you get it?
Since morning.
So she went there with you?
Yes, sir.
Okay. All right, I just want Windy, just wanted Windy to acknowledge publicly that him get the $10,000. And his, all right, Windy want to play like one piece of music in appreciation. Hold on, 1 minute, in bank account number is 305-018-961. 305-018-961. Thank you very much. Windy, why go and play?
Yes. Our listeners, good morning.
Yeah.
My greatest respect and love and honor to those who does not help me and those who is going to help me and those who helped me already. My love for you all and guidance in the election, and that everyone will just live good and help children in the little way you can. I'm going to pray a very well-known hymn, Praise My Soul, the King of Heaven. Blessed. Thank you.
you play a piece of Windy, man, the whole time music Windy.
Yes, go ahead.
Terrible and dreadful. Terrible, 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 terrific. Yeah, thank you very much, Windy. All right, thank you very much.
Blessed.
We are going to go straight to the phone because we don't want people credit run out, although them get a lovely piece of something for free there. Thank you very much. Take hold up your mouth, dog. And good morning and welcome to Straight Up, hello?
Small!
Welcome, Wagwan.
Small!
What is that? Yeah, man. I am good, or I'm a young chap.
Yeah, uncle, I'm a lot younger than you are.
Yes. So what go on?
Anyway, what you call yourself the other day? When you were talking to Jimmy Russell, you never say you're a rebel. What were you I can't remember.
What is that? Freedom fighter, I don't know.
Yeah. Well, you was a freedom fighter. You always bowing back to Babylon, you know, you.
Tell me what go.
You bow back to Babylon.
Tell me what go, man. Tell me.
Because the other day you come, was it Monday, you come off and you lick some chat. I was very disappointed, but at least you have the ability to come back and say, I'm sorry.
Yes, and not that you call about to Babylon?
No, but you always about to Babylon.
No, tell me about it then, because you're not telling about it then.
You want to go to Babylon, you're a land, you're a Manchester, and the white boy then go for Russia. Because you want to peep you up the wall.
Yeah.
you know my years.
And so what?
Born and bred here. No white boy never come to me with their feet better.
No, because you see them have you in them pocket.
No. Me stand up for me believe in
that. Mm-hmm.
My parents come here in the 60s and me leave here and then me come and make a 65 and leave 80. The white boy never bring them finger to me. Never.
So what happened now? You think I should have hide that experience I'm going to go through?
No, to be honest, I appreciate some of the experiences you've gone through because it's a good example. For example, you mentioning that your old man wrote a dissertation at the University of London and you mentioned socialism and you was marked down for it.
Yeah.
These are things that happen, but what? Even now, it's not about what you think. It's not the person's marking your paper want you to write because of what's in the syllabus or the specification.
Yeah, when you are given a composition, when you are given the opportunity to write a composition, you are not only permitted but expected to give your opinion also. So you're not supposed
no,
to.
No, but your opinion must be supported by evidence.
Yeah, and you are saying that when a student displeases an institution or an examiner and is marked down, it is always justified.
You're not going to get the mark.
I'm asking you just a simple question. You are saying that when an institution or an examiner marks down a student because they are displeased with his opinion, it is always justified. Yes or no?
It is justified because that's not what they're looking for.
Well, you sound like you are the one who bought to Babylon.
Well, I'm doing what was required.
Cost it what it will. Yeah.
Go by, and I'm dealing with it.
Cost it what it will.
Anyway. Hey, Maccabee come from nearby Birmingham,
yeah,
you know.
Yeah, yeah.
But, well, look, let me tell you something. It's when me come back, after me left drug, me come to Jamaica since I was a youngster, and me come back here. And what I will tell you is, by the recognition of the things that Rasta's done in this country, did change the pace.
Yeah.
The only problem is, Rasta didn't get themselves educated.
Yes, well, a lot. The women, that, you know what that
the women.
Yeah.
The women, their partners did, or their wives did, and when the wives get them degree, the wives kick them to the curb.
You're generalizing and you're painting with a broad brush and you're damaging your own credibility.
I'm telling you, it's a fact.
Yes, but it's not such a broad brush as what you're trying to paint with.
It is a broad brush. Tell me, how many 50-year-olds?
You
went to university.
Yes, okay. When we get more time, we'll talk some more, but it's not as broad a brush as what you want to.
It is as broad. We need to deal with it more.
All right. All right. Yeah, man. Thanks a lot. Yes, sir. Next one. Good morning. Welcome to Straight Up. Huh?
Yeah, man. I'm telling you, if you're not careful, them 10, 20 years down the line, they're going to say them, the developer starting and say, wait. Anyhow, the head of the WHO, something I understand it's possible she has a brain tumor. And the Americas need to chew power needs to issue a statement because she's creating a systematic, as it draws closer to Rio, she's creating this systematic panic. She keep coming out and she keep escalating the thing, moving closer and closer to Code Red. And if you really examine the situation, because I saw a news item last night and watching one of the international stations, a young journalist in Brazil said she was born with the Maya or whatever head. And she's not qualified. She's an excellent journalist. And last night again you watch this young mother out here. And is that she's begging for her baby to have it. And something needs to be done. A statement needs to be issued to CARICOM and to PAHO to counter this lady's presentation as head of the WHO. Because it is a deliberate action. Because when the United States CDC department is sitting there and their second strongest frontier to exploit the wealth of the earth is through the pharmaceutical industry. And one of the things they are developing is vaccine for all the known diseases that doesn't have vaccine. And so they're deliberately creating this panic, wanting to reduce the number of children that are being born to black females. I don't know about the other race, I'm talking about my race. And another thing, the power of the Obama was pushing the homosexual agenda. He went to Africa with it, he came to the Caribbean with it. It has been rejected all around. And so,
Hold on. Now if Obama is said to be pushing the homosexual agenda, you could never leave out your leader as one of the most influential, 100 most influential people in the world pushing the homosexual agenda.
He's not doing so.
Look here, you're living in a false world.
All right. You remember what they were saying, that during the debate she said that she would do whatever with the bugger law? She has completed a full four years. And she's calling it, she has called election.
And what?
She hasn't the law.
She hasn't fulfilled that promise.
No, she hasn't.
So that is why war.
She didn't promise.
Hold on. You're not going to dominate the whole thing, man. You give more than 2 minutes to start, and we have 1 minute left, and you want to come dominate the whole thing. So therefore, what Warboat said earlier, the lady with name Warboat, that Portia lie. I want to see what you're talking about then.
Yeah, Portia did not say. She did not promise. She said what she would do.
All right, look here. Call her back early.
I don't know. Conscience vote.
I don't know why you wait till so late in the program. But now, war. You have supplied Warboat with some of the material that she was looking for. But
well,
call
her. Warboat. Yes, yes. Lie on the lady.
Yeah, but you know that Portia is a batlax. Yes. Thank you very much.
She has done credit. And she has
Caribbean. Yes. Next one, please. Good morning. Welcome to Straight Up. Hello.
Hello.
Welcome. Good morning, ma'am.
Yes, good morning, sir.
How are you doing, ma'am?
Not bad. 3 quick points.
Yes, ma'am.
Somebody mentioned to me the other day that the PNP has really hijacked the JLP's agenda.
Yeah.
Remember once when they used to wear Kariba and talk about socialism?
Yes.
And it was Siaga who was in the three-piece suit and was holding up Washington?
Yeah, yeah.
Well, they have come full circle.
Yeah.
Perhaps too, because the globe has changed.
Yes.
Then the next quick thing, ZigV.
Yeah.
I get the impression they are recommending that people put off having sex for about 3 years.
Even the government, though?
Well, I don't know, that's the impression I am getting, but the Catholics cannot do that, so we might have some problems.
So what we are witnessing here in Jamaica is elective surgery. Now the political scene is elective surgery. Them carry out elective surgery from Portia.
Well, I would know, sir.
When I say electoral surgery, because yes. She don't really want to go.
Yes.
And then push her, but she not feel pleased at all. I could see it on her face while Peter Phillips was talking.
Yes, one more quick point.
Yeah.
Black History Month.
Yes, ma'am.
Looking at some information on the origins of Christianity, and it's linked to ancient Egyptian religion of Osiris and Isis.
Yeah.
And the parallels are significant, Mr. Saul.
Yeah.
Thousands of years before the coming of Jesus, the Egyptians had a single Trinitarian God, the concept of the Holy Trinity. They dealt with the concept of resurrection, a soul, a final judgment, eternal life, and so on. They also dealt with the concept of, resurrection again, where Osiris became man, and then he died and he was raised from the dead. Now, if these things are really true, have we been misled into believing that Christianity came up with all of these concepts and that these concepts were placed in the Bible on a question of faith? Well, I don't know who investigated it, but it's a serious parallel, and it also has to do, it seems, with attributing modern civilization to the Greeks and Romans and completely excluding the contribution of Egyptian culture and society to modern life. Just a quick comment, but I think this part of history is very relevant to Black history, and for us to understand the history of religions, how people conceive of their gods, how the God developed. Portia believes that God touched her, and earlier on, ancient kings and queens believed that they ruled on behalf of God. Ordinary people had nothing to do with God. And then later, I suppose, God was democratized.
Yes, ma'am.
So it means in Jamaica that God can touch me too and tell me not to vote.
Well, thank you very much. Thank you very much. I appreciate it. Next one, please. We have some text messages to catch up with too. Good morning and welcome to Straight Up, hello. Next one. Good morning, welcome to Straight Up, hello.
Longer, Jerry.
Yes, sir, welcome. Rasta Black.
Greetings, Rasta Black.
Yes, sir.
Welcome. Can I push across three important topics?
Yeah, man, welcome.
Number one, Reggae Month kicked off really good at rehab.
Yeah.
And I thank Newstalk for the support.
Rehab is where?
Rehab is across from Old Hospital Park on the hip strip of Montego Bay, which we're trying to make it the Reggae Walk of Fame hip strip.
Okay.
Friday night is going to be another good night. It's going to be at Margaritaville, and the Reggae Month continues there.
Yes.
Friday night. Next week, we're looking at doing the movie night at Dunway, next Tuesday night.
Yeah.
Next thing, Bunga Vin, the priest from the Naya Bingi house,
yeah.
And not the Naya Bingi, but Rastafari house,
yeah.
Is calling everyone to action, read the Kerr Garden event coming up tomorrow at 1 p.m. sharp. So he's coming over, meeting with all ancients at the Naya Bingi Center in Pit 4 at 1 p.m. tomorrow. He asked me to invite all ancients,
yeah.
And specifically ancients.
Yes.
And the third thing, all independent candidates, the day after nomination, Jamaica Alliance Movement is inviting everyone. The place... The venue is not yet decided, but we have to get together in Montego Bay to plan a call to action, plan of action. So it's going to be next the day after the 10th.
All right.
It's going to be here in Montego Bay.
There is
call
a,
to action.
There's an independent candidate in Westmoreland there, Haile Mikael, I believe.
Yes.
And there's one in St. Elizabeth, Mr. Pattison. I forget what his first name is. You contact any of them yet?
Yeah, we'll be sending out, I just sent out an email with everyone, including registered third parties. So we're inviting all the people from the...
No,
NDF,
but no, no, hold on a minute. No, hold on a minute, please. I'm talking about contacting them. Because I think it would be good if you reach out and go meet them personally, different from sending an email.
Yeah, I am in the process of.
Yeah, man.
I'm in the process of.
I don't think you should have make another week pass before you do that, you know, because...
Come no, here, it,
hold on, hold on a minute, hold on a minute.
After nominated,
hold on a minute,
nomination
please.
Day is when I'm calling that action.
Yeah, but I'm saying, it is not, it's not going to be most effective if you call the people them together, you don't try to meet them personally before that. Because it's a real and serious and necessary thing that needs to be done. But meeting people personally and reaching out, I really think it's necessary rather than making contact first by the email. But, you know, it's just my thoughts because really and truth.
I understand because I was listening to Fresh Start with Mike Henry.
Yeah.
And Mike Henry said that's the kind of culture we still have here in Jamaica. The internet and emailing and WhatsApping and Instagram, although it is good for the most of the younger voters, but he's saying they still the touch hand and kiss baby and things.
Not kiss baby. Nothing will ever replace people meeting face to face. But thank you very much. I mean, I encourage you all the way. Here's all the way.
Tomorrow is very important.
Yeah,
all of them coming to Pit 4 at 1 p.m. meeting
all
sharp.
Right.
We call that.
Thank you very much. Here's next one, please. Morning. Welcome to Straight Up.
Morning, Jerry.
Welcome.
Quickly, I want to talk about the minister who is getting a bit of flack for his partisan prayers. It's work. But I am also a member of that particular organization, so I'm speaking from school now. That particular organization, I remember the president at the stadium sometime when Mr. Sierra was in power, publicly on television and radio, endorsing Sierra. And Sierra was the one, when he got up to speak, who gave a disclaimer.
The president of what?
Of the Seventh-day Adventist organization, his name was Noel Fraser.
What year was that?
Sometime in the 80s, Jerry. I can't do the math, but, you know, last night I was talking to a friend and it came back to me.
Yes.
Fraser finished talking about Thiago's upbringing as a Seventh-day Adventist mother, father, etc., etc., when Thiago got up, Thiago said all churches, the whole of them was looking to the sky. That's what Tiago said. And nobody said anything to Fraser then or since.
No, hold on. When Tiago said all the churches are looking to the sky, what do you mean?
He meant that there was no substantive difference. So to be labeling him as Adventist and painting him as Seventh-day Adventist.
No, hold on.
Was neither here nor
hold,
there.
Hold on. You
said what the gentleman was trying to do.
Yeah, but you said that Tiago made a disclaimer. I thought you was going to say that Tiago said the Seventh-day Adventist Church must not be charged with this favor that the individual pastor was giving him, but must be cleared out. I thought it was that he was going to do, but...
And just moving beyond, because I heard that, like, it's an economical ganging up on the gentleman. Errol Blair, during that period also, actually named his church, you know, Deliverance Center. You know why it was named that, Jerry? Because he was one of the chief advocates of the JLP.
Now you heard me say that here Arabier lent them some support in the 80 election and so on. Would you allow me? Why are you trying to over?
I thought you asked me a question, Jerry.
I asked no question.
You said you heard me say. And what? I didn't hear.
Thank you very much. We're not going to reach anywhere now. Next one, please. Next one.
Hey,
morning, Zawagwan.
Morning. But I hear Siaga say yesterday, you know, Jerry. You hear me?
Yeah.
They have a PNP. He called election in December. The Labour right would wipe out the PNP.
Christopher Siaga.
Siaga was born in America.
Christopher Siaga.
I don't know if you call him Christopher Tiaga.
Yeah. He has a son.
Former leader of the jail.
Yeah, but he has a son named so, but he apparently is Christopher Columbus also.
Yeah, I got to say if the PNP call election in December.
Yep. Yeah.
Labour I could wipe him out.
That's why the election wasn't called in December.
Yeah. See, I got no what going.
And probably if they call it in this December coming out, maybe, whether December is 2015 or 2016, maybe it's the same result. So Decembers are not good.
Yeah.
Not Decembers are not good at this time. And I don't know.
February is a good month for the PNP.
Oh yeah?
Yeah.
Good.
Take home all the seats.
Alright, take home all the what?
All the seats.
Yeah.
Belong to the JLP and the PNP will become one to push at Timothy Miller.
Yeah. So you are yeah,
25th.
So you are a pastor also?
No, I'm not a pastor.
Oh.
I'm a Worlian.
You're a what?
I'm a Worlian.
Worlian.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Take care yourself.
Yeah, take care of Portia.
Yeah, man.
We have some text messages. I'm going to run them fast. Jerry, you think Peter Phillips care about tax collection or him just target his non-friends? I don't think about it. Next one. The pastor is right because politics and religion are two faces of the same coin. And they are both inimical to human welfare, coming from King Power. I couldn't say that religion is inimical to human welfare. I couldn't say that politics per se is inimical. Inimical means not good. Not good for. I really couldn't say that. A lot of religion and a lot of politics, probably most of it is not wholesome. But I couldn't say that politics and religion per se are inimical to human welfare because they are addressing the needs that people feel. Not addressing it in the best way most of the time, but addressing needs that people feel. People have a need to be organized and people have a need to be reassured spiritually and organized communally and politically. But maybe they did not address properly, but I couldn't mark them off as being inimical to human welfare. Just broadband. So next one. Jerry, it look like say I won't let Jehovah's Witness no sell out. All Rasta them sell out. Text back and demonstrate to me that all Rasta sell out. That's what they must do. Text back and demonstrate to me that all Rasta sell out. Next one. Jerry, the so-called poor, not poor. We have some of the most expensive things, lifestyle and habits, from phone to clothes to cars. Check it. No, if people have some of the most expensive things, they are not poor. You're not talking about the poor. You're talking about working class culture people. People can be of a certain culture and not have the same economy. People can be of working class culture, or they can be of Muslim culture and rich, and they can be of Muslim culture and poor. They can be of working class culture and not poor. You can be a working class culture and poor. But you could never be poor and have some of the most expensive class. You're contradicting yourself, please, with all due respect. Next one. Neil Bongo Jerry. As a means of commemorating Reggae Month, as a special request, could you name the instrument players of solos and the local songs that you selected to play on your program? Could you announce when the events connect to Reggae Month will be kept at the Edna Manley School of Arts from Tony Brown? Well, yeah, you preempt me because Those instrumentalists that I know and remember, sometimes I mention them, I can do more, but I don't remember and know all of them. And also, I neglected, I had the paper here and meant to read out about the event that was taking place at Edna Manley School yesterday evening, starting a series of Tuesday evenings and others. But it was so crowded, I never get to do it. And I plan, and I have the list here of events coming up from week to week to read out. Thank you very much. Right up where I was thinking and going. Next one. Salute, Mr. Small. We are at work on Martha Vineyard, Massachusetts, and trust me, man, you have us entertained and educated with your vast tsunami and company. Thank you very much. Next one. JP White, not right. Clear your taxes. How can you be trusted coming from what? From I? No, from 4I. Next one. Jerry, away you rub up with, make you get them fierce disease. Tell me the fierce disease I may have. I maybe can tell you what I'm rub up with. But I don't really rub with anything that pertain to you. But if you rub us the wrong way, you're not going to like it still. Next way. Them bongo, you never hear said the goodly reverend was recently given a big post by Portia. So you have to be singing for a supper coming from Errol Abson. Yes, it adds up. Next one. It no make no sense voting in JLP. We have no more. We have to move from them. Sometime, let's keep going on, coming from Vervine. Next one, Mr. Small, like, how you not ready yet with party? Would you tell them to vote? Who would you tell them to vote for? Vervin. I don't see anyone there. I don't see anyone there worthwhile to vote for. But I know that there are people worthwhile of representing the people in Jamaica. It's just that them not put themselves forward. But one day, all of this picking and choosing and changing our candidates and overturning the both parties, not them doing it. They're acting like it's them doing it and they're in control. They are not in control. It's something that is happening to them. A bigger thing is happening to both of the parties. It's just a symptom of coming things. Just hold on, little clear soon, see. Next one. In the USA, tax evasion go to jail. Tax evaders go to jail no matter how rich and famous they are. Why not the same in Jamaica? One day it might be so. Don't worry, believe. Don't rule it out. Next one. Jerry, the fact that Mr. White know that he owes tax and trying to represent the party lacks integrity. Next one. Jerry, how come Hillary Clinton can take questions from the press and Porsche run from the press? It's two different people completely. Two different people. Two different kind of people. Two different kind of country. Next one. Faculty of General Learning, straight up Professor Bongo Small. Coming from what? From Lionport, thank you very much. But I don't profess to be a professor. But thanks for the compliment anyway. Next one, Jerry, who said the PNP will be in office until God come? Text coming from Anansi. Next one, Jerry, morning, if JLP win, country mashup. I think that is it. Let's get back to the phone. Good morning and welcome to Straight Up, hello?
Yeah, Bongo, Jerry.
Yes, sir, welcome, Wagwan.
Yeah, I'll back to you about the comments. Congress lady.
Yeah, talk up a little louder for me. Yeah,
Congress lady seems to me like a conference.
Oh, okay. Yes, Congress lady, yeah. Yeah, Senator. Yeah.
So no bastard no there again. You don't know why should I say that, Jerry.
Why?
Remember in the PGA era, PGA did come and say more man have more girl enough.
Yeah.
This time, you know.
Yeah.
So all them, she and Peter Phillips said it, you know.
Yeah.
Man can't have no woman at this time.
Eh?
And they can't have no bugger woman.
Yeah.
I go around and I breed no bugger woman at this time, yeah.
Yeah.
So you find out, say, no bastard not really.
Oh, neither bastard nor bastard.
Well, good, Jerry. I want to the Friday night. You know, it's over Portmore, I'm there.
Yeah.
Friday night, boating at about 10 o'clock. I smell this when the mother this, you know, in time the fogging,
yeah.
I smell there.
Yeah.
I mean, I say fogging at 10 o'clock in the night.
Yeah.
But the geographical things here, you know, it's a nighttime land breeze.
Yeah.
Land breeze come and go to sea.
Yeah.
I think I'm more or less somewhere in the inner Portmore.
Yeah, further in.
Yeah, further in, because you know, so me down from the south, I go down to Elshire.
Oh, yes.
So I said, oh, really, I go on. So everything really come to light now. I did say, here are them, where in a Portmore, where the youth
oh.
come with the chick.
Oh, the one where I'm
passed
through Dallas.
Fogging and Dallas. Thing.
Oh, yes.
So it really come back to me, you know, and find out that's really a go on. But there's nothing wrong in the naming of the basically the era with.
Yeah, naming and identifying the era where the youth come live. Because remember, if the youth come live back there, while them had the chick V before him get over it, his mosquito in that area. But come bite him and carry to somebody else. Why they don't want to alert people?
I don't know.
Why?
I don't know. Why them not alert people?
What they doing?
Bad gas?
No, because they are protecting that area, from any stigma, because they want to turn it into a PNP garrison. Portmore them say belong to them as a garrison. That's the latest garrison that I'm trying to construct. That's why after the mayor dead, them still not keep no more election for keep no mayor. They are shameless. Next one. But thank you very much. Yeah.
Bless up.
Good morning and welcome to Straight Up. Hello.
Hello, morning, Mr. Small.
Welcome, sir. How are you doing, sir?
Yeah, respect, Mr. Small. Mr. Small, you know, one of the things that the Jamaican people must realize, the level of money and sex that is behind this whole political setup.
Yeah.
And if they would know some of the people who are pulling the strings of the politicians, they wouldn't vote for none of them.
No.
Because you really have some savvy people behind the scenes.
Yes.
The journey to Westmoreland the other day on Saturday teaches me a lot of things.
Yeah.
There's a lot of politicians in cabinet.
Yeah.
Was a lot of land across the country.
Yes.
Just sitting down there idling.
Yeah.
And I wonder why they are accumulating so much land.
No, but you shouldn't wonder. I think you wonder how they're getting away with it.
Yes, and how they manage to get so much land.
Yeah.
Secondly, Mr. Small, as part of the Black History Month celebration.
Yeah.
I would encourage every member of the family, if you have a 10-year-old child, especially a boy child,
yeah,
encourage them to start saving $30 out of every $100 that they get hold of.
Yes.
As part of their pension.
Yeah.
Start putting away 30% of their lunch money as part of the pension.
Yes.
Because this carefree attitude of buying these snacks every day and eating unnecessary things.
Yeah.
It won't last forever.
Yes, yes.
And some of them may believe that.
Some of them don't believe that.
That a God will come before they get old.
Yes, yes.
They have another guest coming.
Yes.
Secondly, Mr. Small, people yeah. over 40 should try and ensure that they can bury themselves when they die.
Yeah.
To take that burial stress off their children. Because most of the children won't be able to carry that expense anymore.
Yeah.
I firmly believe every adult should be able to bury themselves when they die.
All right.
To give you more peace of mind in death.
Yes, yes. All right, thanks a lot for that, dear sir.
Take care here, Mr. Spahn.
Yes, sir. Another one. Good morning and welcome to Straight Up, hello? Morning, welcome to Straight Up, hello? Is it there? Text message.
Hello? Hello?
Yeah, number this one, please. Good morning and welcome to Straight Up, hello?
Yes, sir. Yeah, thank you. Premier.
Yes, welcome.
You were mentioning earlier talking about the relationship
26.
With the Christianity.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. If she look into it, you know, she needs to think about when Greece
yeah.
took over the world.
Yeah.
And that's when the Greece changed just the total concept of what is right. Go ahead and think about Hellenism when they corrupt the original history. Aman.
Yeah.
Right? And so when they create all that corruption, because what we call the Maccabee version, it was written by the Egyptians. It was written because, they created...
Hold on a minute. What is the Maccabee version?
The Maccabee version was written to oppose...
No, I don't ask you what it was written to do, you know. I'm asking you, what is the Maccabee version?
The Maccabee version was written by the Maccabees. They are called the Ammon.
What is the Maccabee version?
It's a section of the Bible that is not in the current King James Bible. And it was written by Palestinian Egyptians.
Hold on. Palestinian Egyptians, what do you mean?
No, because they were Palestinians, not really the Arabs. They are really a set of dark Egyptians, Africans then. And it was written by them to oppose Hellenism, because Hellenism corrupt the
original concept. All right,
okay, all right. All
right, hold on. Let's go for a break and come back. Hello, sir, are you there?
Yeah, man. All right.
Well, no, hold on. The Maccabees version, what is the message of the Maccabees version? What is the message in those books?
You have the book of Judith?
No, I don't want a list of the names. I'm asking you, what is the message of those books?
The message of those books is about resistance to being colonized by a foreign country. That's the message of the book.
Yeah.
That's the real essence of the book.
Yeah, and who were the Maccabees?
The Maccabees were the people who opposed Hellenism. They opposed the Greeks.
Yeah, but what set of people was named Maccabee? Which set of people?
They were actually Palestinian Jews.
Yeah, but it's not a family.
It's a family, yes.
All right, listen here.
Listen here.
Hello.
Mm-hmm.
Go and check it out somewhere. You call us back and you give us a more concise account of who the Maccabees were and what they were about and so on. But thank you very much, yeah? Next one. Good morning and welcome to the
show. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Wagwan.
Well, I'm in the honor now.
Yeah.
I just joined the crew. I was out doing some little work.
Yeah.
I come back and talk, you know.
Yeah.
By the way, the question that Dion Jack
Martin ask Mrs. Linda.
Yeah.
We're coming up to the election there.
Yeah.
You know, I asked Dan Jackson came on the what's feeling in I talk to what we Emil Wanda in there.
Yeah. Yeah.
I mean, after I said, why did you ask that question?
What was the question?
About some repealing that is. You know what I mean, man? Because I'm going to go back. Right?
No, you know, you have to go back. Listen here. No, you bring up something on the program. No, you listen. No, listen. You bring up something on the program.
Yes.
People are listening. People
yes.
want to
yes.
know
but
what.
But you also know.
No, I don't know. I don't know. I have not made a mention of it. I don't know. I didn't
you
know
hear. So why you? What you're saying that Mrs. Miller is pushing agenda of
from years ago. It have nothing to do with Dion Jackson Miller recently. Man. But tell me what.
Dion Jackson. Yeah. It was a debate.
Yeah. With who?
With she and Andrew Hornets.
Oh.
And she, they asked a question and she answered the question. But I asked Dan Jackson Miller why she asked the question.
Yeah.
And I told Dan Jackson, if it was me, like Mrs. Miller, I wouldn't answer at all.
Why?
But she has to bring up any kind of question.
What kind of question? Which question?
What I was telling you.
What was the question?
Listen, man. When you get information, you talk. Because it's so many times you talk with no go, sir.
No, listen here.
Bye-bye, sir.
Boom, bye-bye. Next one. Good morning and welcome to Straight Up, hello.
Yeah, morning.
Right? Welcome, sir.
Oh yeah, it's a young photographer. You know?
Young photographer, what going on? You did send a picture, come give me.
Yeah.
All right, who you give it to?
All right, so when I came to Lambert and...
No, hold on. Who you give it to?
Lambert, bro.
Why?
Because he was the only person that answered the door when I came there.
No, but what did they tell you must do?
I don't remember.
No, I'm not hearing you at all.
I don't remember.
I told him I must bring it here between the hours that I am here. No, talk up now when I hear your voice.
It's the time that I leave work.
No, listen. I appreciate it very much. But it is not useful. It's not useful to give it to Lambert or anybody else. But I appreciate it very much. I get it here, sir.
You got it?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
I don't know if them process it or what, but I get it.
All right.
I don't know if them fingerprinted. But thank you very much. Nice picture.
Yeah, man, cool.
You show how tired I was at the time, too.
Yeah.
Eh?
Yeah, because I walk up and down, you know.
No, I know walk up and down, make me tired, you know. But I like nice picture, I appreciate you. Bring it for me, man. Walk on.
Yeah, man, cool, man.
Everything good?
Not all, but I try work on it.
PJ say, you know, PJ Patterson. Mm-hmm. Said, don't make hungry man carry your food. You understand me?
Yeah, but there you
go. You get the message?
Yeah, mommy, get the message.
My father born ya. I don't want song name the message, you know. And PJ said, don't make hungry man carry your food. I'm going to play a piece of music. Hey, you fat man. anything else good?
Well, I'll work on it for the rest of the day.
Yes, man. Good, man. Well, all the success to you in your photography here, sir.
Respect.
Thank you very much.
Cool.
Next one. Good morning and welcome to Straight Up. My office, I welcome your picture.
Yeah, good morning.
Yes, ma'am. Speak of the angel.
Yes, Jerry.
And there is.
And good morning to all my brothers and sisters wherever you are at.
Yes, ma'am.
In the beautiful garden that our Holy Father has blessed us with.
Yeah.
With everything in it.
Yeah.
All we need and all we want.
Yeah.
You understand?
Yes, ma'am.
All right, now, Jerry, you remember them used to have a song say, you know, mama has a beat you with it. Oh, that is a song, let it go, Jerry.
I don't know anything about your mama song. How are we going?
Jerry, you know, mama has a beating up. I don't know, Mr. Star Pune, you know.
Yeah.
One hug on the Jerry.
Who is Uno?
You.
You know, like... Yeah.
You and Sheffield.
Yes.
And Fox.
Yes.
What Uno has a do yeah. when that thing that take on Jerry, you remember the last election?
Yeah.
Yeah, Mr. Water says in the east and so.
Yes.
And I say a piece of breeze blew up.
Yeah. Mama pass.
What?
Is mama pass it?
No, it was a strong breeze.
Said smell
east, yeah.
Why is it smell strong?
Jerry.
Call me back early tomorrow.
What I got to do? What I got to do when tell us thing that take
us? Just cock your nose till it blow, eh? Thank you very much. Next call. Hello, do cock your nose.
Bless you, brother Jerry.
Welcome, sir. I go on.
Give thanks and eyes is better.
Yeah.
And to the eye. First one coming up.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. I got a Joseph likewise.
Yeah, great for now.
Yes, give thanks. I see the sign and of the time, you know?
Yeah, man.
Yes, it's right. As I say, I glad to know so the eye upkeep in such a manner, I make I have to call the eye even Rascal, sir.
Yes, sir.
And the eye fit the position, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah, the eye fit the position of the role of Rascal, sir, did appear.
Yes, sir.
To a certain aspect.
Good job.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. So, as I said, brother, just go on, maintain the high truth, equality and justice and balance of standards and action, because it's important, you know, and whenever time I and I see where I and I blunder, I and I quickly apologize and mend such rim. So I give thanks to all such humility at the high said here, because that is strengthening the high said here.
Yeah, man, thank you very much, yes, huh?
I not done yet.
Oh, well, go ahead.
Yes, sir. So I say, to all Jamaican citizens, to what I observe, I know they are saying catching here why just several years I'm come forward in a limited same catching in a 1999.
Yeah.
And the amount of crime where I see happen in a limited same catching.
Yeah.
And when I saw it out, are the PNP and JLP behind all of it?
You know, sir, I want you to call back early tomorrow. Cause when you call me so late, I can't get from me. And I want to hear more about it. Because all gang they are linked now. Big, big gang.
Naturally.
All right. Tomorrow you call me early and tell you more. Here, sir, please.
Blessed and all the best.
Thank you very much. The next one, please. Good morning and welcome to Straight Up. Hello.
Good morning.
Hi, ma'am. How are you doing, ma'am?
Good morning.
Well, you sound like you're underwater, like war boats, eh, man?
Let me tell you. My question, you see?
Yeah, ma'am.
Is why is it the World Health Organization and others know that the chikungunya virus is dangerous and also is deadly? Why create it in the lab?
Yeah, who said them created in them lab?
It is created. It is a thing that is created. It is chikungunya. And also the Zigbee and the Zigbee now. Because Zigbee, what I understand now, is a muscle that is fed on herpes and E. coli and sheep's blood. Why is it they do these things, no one releases on the entire world? It's a global thing. Why?
You're asking those things and you're not demonstrating how you know that is them, dude. You're not demonstrating that at all.
Because it was in the papers about the Zigbee thing.
You're not talking clear at all. You're talking very vague about the Zigbee thing.
These things, you see, must be something that is created in a lab. It cannot be just the other monsters, right? It must be something that's created. Your own common sense should tell you that. Right? Something that's created in a lab. You understand? And they know it is detrimental to the people and to the entire population. Why do it? And now they're telling you, these people must get cured for it. There's no cure for these things. Because I think they along with the pharmaceutical companies, are in agreement with this sort of thing. To create these things and unleash it on the people. And then now
Out of time completely, ma'am. Call early tomorrow. When you call so late, it's very inconvenient. But thank you very much, yeah, ma'am. Text message. Could you repeat the numbers to register for the presentation by Dr. Dennis Howard? I'm going to have to go repeat them tomorrow. I didn't get them secure yet. Tomorrow. Next one. Jerry Windy was the first person to put an engine on a cat. I'm going to talk about your Windy.
Yes,
next
sir.
One. Jerry, what is Windy's right name? What's your right name, Windy?
George Dixon.
That's, if you're making out the check, you make it out. So George Dixon. All right. We still need info to send the money. All right. George Dixon. Next one. Jerry, $1,000 can help Windy. Because it's so small. But him just bless my soul with prayers. Praise my soul, the King of Heaven, the music we play. Thank him very much. You say $1,000 can help Windy because it's so small. No, man. Whether it's small or not, it helps. Next one. Jerry, if people now make it, stop them from have sex. This Zico think you think I will stop them? Madness, that woman talk. No, people are warned about things. Some people ignore it. Not because them say that is madness. If you want, take heed, take heed. Next one. The caller who continually spouts incorrect information about the population of black America. Here's a correction. There are 42 million black Americans. Okay. Next one. Morning, Jerry. This is a censor. I can't read out that. I can't read out that. Next one. Morning, Jerry. The Zika virus is in Portmore. I get all the symptoms of the virus 2 weeks ago. Next one. Morning, Jerry. I brown man from Mandeville do not see Mr. Aubin Bartlett. That's a JLP candidate. Seems he's not interested in winning the seat. For foresightly, he's going to defeat Bunting by 50-odd votes. Next one. Good morning, Mr. Small. Could you play Peter Trott's song each day on your program? I can't promise you that, maybe, but I can't promise you. Next one. This brother presentation sounds much like Tony Gregory. I think you're talking about the first singer, the first brother who came, Mr. Wilson. All right, the one-day workshops, Mr. The numbers to contact to register for Mr. Howard, Dr. Dennis Howard's thing is 906-4515. 906-4515. Cell 466-6933. Now tonight, Bammy Rose and Maurice Gardner and others are going to be presenting a nice jazz concert and thing up at Waterloo Road at the Gore Business Center. Waterloo Road, I can't remember how much Waterloo Road, but Waterloo Road somewhere up in the Mega Mart area. Bammy Rose and Maurice Gardner and some more. Try get there. A lot of other things I wanted to read out about, but I don't have the time. Tomorrow we'll read out more about them, including Clinton Hutton's lecture tomorrow evening. But I want to thank my producer, Tanya Richards. I want to thank production assistant. She is Kelisha Williams, and broadcast technician Yahin Stewart. And you haven't added the brother's name, but you have to go put it on next time. 12 o'clock news, straight up till tomorrow.
PNP General Secretary Paul Burke calls on John Paul White to release documents proving he has settled a $17 million tax debt. MP for West Portland, Daryl Vaz, speaks out against Industry, Investment and Commerce Minister Anton Hilton in defense of former Prime Minister Eddie Siaga. Members of the JLP say they are not troubled by the recent Don Anderson polls, and three people shot and killed in St. James and a fourth person seriously injured.